Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to Chanute High School, home of the Chanute Blue Comets. This contest is being played under the authority of the Kansas State High School Activities Association, whose rules provide for fair play and good sportsmanship among athletes and coaches. Respect for the officials, players, and coaches, and respect for the host facilities are expected and essential for the success of this athletic event. We encourage you, as fans and spectators, to applaud fair play, respect the rights of those around you, and to promote only the highest ideals of good sportsmanship. In accordance with the Kansas State Fire Marshal, we request that you take a moment to recognize the emergency exits closest to you. A reminder that the use of tobacco products in any form within our buildings belonging to Chanute USD 413 is strictly prohibited. We thank you for your cooperation in upholding our policies. And just a reminder, sale prices. We've got Ralph Miller gear from the Chanute FBLA. T-shirts are $10, all sizes. Crews are $17 and hoodies are $22. And another reminder, we do have hoops for cash, so you can buy your ticket at the concession stand. All proceeds today at concession stand go to Foreign Language Club. Now, if you'll please stand, face the flag with your hands over your heart as we honor this great country of ours with the national anthem.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. It's day number three of the 52nd annual Ralph Miller Classic. I am DJ Dangerfield, and we got another great Kansas High School basketball game for you. We got the Shining Mission South Raiders taking on the Andover Central Jaguars. The Jaguars from Andover Central looking for their first win of this tournament. And Shining Mission South is looking to do a clean sweep this afternoon in our game one. The game two, your beloved Chanute Blue Comets will be facing against the Piper Pirates here. And so looking at some of the starting lineups for both these clubs, we'll start with the Shining Mission South Raiders. They're starting my man, Kalen Gregory. He's number one, the 5'11 junior. The 5'11 junior, number three, Brody Featherston. He got second today in the three-point contest. 6'5 sophomore, number five, Drake DeBond, the man down low for Shawnee Mission South. He has put together a very good tournament here. Young cat, phenomenal post play, phenomenal perimeter play. He's a global player. It's been fun to watch him during this tournament. Number 15, the 6'6 junior, Jadon Sauter. He also was in the three-point contest. He either got second or third. I can't remember. I have to look it up. I'll look it up and get that right for you. But Jadon Sauter, very good shooter. He hasn't shot like he can normally shoot in this tournament, but this young man can shoot the ball. He's a junior. And then the 6'4 sophomore, number 20, Max McKenna, man, he showed out yesterday. Had a phenomenal game. If I remember correctly, he scored 20 points yesterday in the ball game. He really showed out as a sophomore. And it's been the story of young players here in this tournament. Now for the Jaguars, number two, the 5'6 junior, number two, Jaden Brown. He's their point guard. He'll be starting tonight, 6'6 junior. number four, Brant Stupka, also starting tonight for the Jaguars. Also, Brody DeJarmo, number five, 5'10 junior. Number 12, 5'11 junior, Jace Jefferson, also starting. And number 23, 6'2 junior, Jace Adler. Central lost a tough game last night to the Blue Comets. It came down to the wire in that game, and they fought really, really hard. And so they're looking for their first win. And folks, I'm telling you, they're very well coached. They're going to be hungry. These kids don't back down from anybody. Watching Brody DeJarmo, Jaden Brown, they got really big hearts. And they're facing off against a really good South team. A lot of young players, coach really well, play really well. And that's the thing I've been most impressed with, man. It's been great play, great coaching. I mean, if you are a fan of basketball, this weekend, this has been one of the better Ralph Millers I've watched in years in person. Just an unbelievable display of good old-fashioned basketball. Great coaching. And here we go. It's going to be my man DeBon. He's going to be jumping against my man Jace Adler. Here we go, folks. Game one here in the 52nd annual Ralph Miller Classic, tipping off here tonight, this afternoon. And DeBon wins that fairly easy. Clock is rolling. We're getting this ball game started. Ooh, look at Jaden Brown up on Gregory. Man-to-man defense, and Gregory being a hassle here early. And the pressure by the Jaguars. Man-to-man defense. They're switching on screens, as you can see there. Sauter going against Adler. Down low, Sauter. Out to DeBon. DeBon has been the man in this tournament, probably the MVP here early. And they're going to call a foul on Jefferson here. That's going to be the first team foul. DeBon, just strong kid. He knows he can play the international game, but he can also play like the old school American post player, just down low. Bully you a little bit. Long three by Featherston off the mark. DeBon tries to rebound and falls down, and quickly down the floor comes the Jaguars, and they turn it over. Their first one. That's a problem for Andover Central. From time to time, they have a tendency to turn the ball over. Keep an eye on that today. Had a chance to get a basket in transition. Turned it over. Look at Max. Strong to the basket. A little contact there. No call. McKenna. And there's Adler. And it's blocked by DeBon, and a foul's called. And if you're the coach, yeah, I'm wondering on that one too, coach. McKenna gets knocked down here. DeBon, he had a clean block, and he gets called for the foul. It's going to be the first free throw shot today as Jace Adler's going to the line for Central. His first shot is up, and it's good. Adler's had a great tournament also, especially that first night. He came out that first night, scored 20, almost 20 points that first night. He scored, I think, 18. He knocks down both of the free throws for Central. Central takes the first lead of this game. Adler gets him on the board. There's pressure. Full court pressure by Central here. Full court pressure. They did a lot of that against Chanute last night. Able to force some turnovers. You know, Blue Comets only had two turnovers last night. And when they went into that pressure, Central started picking Chanute up full court and putting on that pressure. Chanute ended up with 8 or 9 turnovers in the second half. They're pressuring the ball here. Here's Featherston going against DeJarmo. Tough kid, DeJarmo. Tough kid. Great defense by DeJarmo on the baseline. Got DeBon. He's working against Adler here. DeBon takes a dribble. Look at that strong movement. We're going to call a foul there on Adler. DeBon, just a sophomore. It's going to be second team foul for the Jaguars. 6:33 to go, 2-0. Nice little defensive ball game here, and we've seen some great defense in this tournament this weekend. McKenna going against Jefferson. Here's Sauter. He goes inside of DeBon. That's where he likes it, off the glass and good. And that young man's tough down there. He knows how to finish down there. We got a tie ball game here, just in the first quarter. 52nd annual Ralph Miller Classic. Now, Central's wearing white, and the Raiders are in their neon green. Shawnee Mission South's in their neon green. That's Brown. He's been guarded by Sauter out there. They switch with DeBon. That's Brown looking inside, nothing there. Good defense up front here. We're going to call a hold down low. It looks like it's going to be on Featherston. They threw the ball inside to Stupka. They call a hold, looks like, on the inside on Featherston. Featherston been a great shooter so far in this tournament. He was also in the three-point contest today. Try to get the ball inside, tipped away, turnover. Good defense that time by Shawnee South. Sauter down the middle of the lane, missed a tough layup. Here comes Brown now in transition, up the floor to Adler. Adler saw DeBon and changed his mind, but there's Brown with the long three, and he knocks it down. He's only 5'6", but he's got the biggest heart out there. Biggest lead of the ball game for the Jaguars here. They're up by three. It's 5-2 here in the first. And the pressure from Andover Central causes a turnover for the Raiders. That's their first turnover tonight. Great pressure by Central. And you can tell Andover wants this game. I love it. Competitive heart. All the kids have been good in this tournament this weekend. Folks, this is a good tournament. Brown turns the corner. Runner in the lane, short. Rebound McKenna for South. Now they're going to come up the floor. And if I'm South, I want to kind of speed it up a little bit, see if I can get something to transition. I want to kind of speed up just a little bit. Boy, because this Central team is sitting down on them on the defensive side. Penetration, great penetration that time. Kalen Gregory, and he has the capability of scoring. He does a great job. Old school point guard, does a great job facilitating the offense. And Gregory is like a coach on the floor. He does a good job of getting the ball to the right player at the right time. Look at that pass. Look at that catch by Featherston. And he's fouled on the three. It looks like they're going to call it on Jefferson. But you just see how you just pay attention to the small things that Gregory does. They don't always show him the stat book. But if you just look at that pass he just made to his teammate, to make sure his teammate caught it in place, we can just catch and shoot it. Gregory, old school, great point guard. Free throw shot up is good by Featherston. Shawnee Mission South shooting their first free throws of the night, of the day, I guess, afternoon. I'm so used to saying night, it's afternoon. Featherston's second free throw off the mark. Checking the ball game is Keach and Kerrigan, the freshman. He's coming in for Sauter and for Gregory, and then coming in for Andover Central. I just saw, oh yeah, it's my man, Max Maddox Archibald checking in. He came in for Jefferson. I think Jefferson has two fouls is why he came in the ball game. So Shawnee Mission South gets two free throws out of three there. Featherston gets on the board for the Raiders. Standing there man-to-man. My man Keach is on the floor for the Raiders. Brown turns the corner, runs some trouble there, kicks out to Brody DeJarmo. Brody DeJarmo throws up off the glass, no good. Rebound Kerrigan. And he does a phenomenal job guarding, does a phenomenal job rebounding. Just a freshman, and he has really made his presence known, Kerrigan off the bench in this tournament. Him and Keach both have. There's McKenna. Great move, strong move to the basket. His first two, he had 14 in the first half yesterday. End up with 18. Jaden Brown getting the call from the coach. A little pressure by the Raiders. Jaden Brown's able to fight it off. Get on that baseline, turns it over. He should have snapped his pass on that one. Third turnover for Andover Central. Great defense by the Raiders. Snapped it. He had the right idea. Snap. Put a little more English on that pass. Keats been guarding tough by Archibald. Now it's McKenna being guarded by Brody. And Brody gets a block there, but the Raiders are able to get the rebound. The Raiders have their first lead of the game. Here is 6-5. There's DeBon. I was wondering when they're going to get the ball to him. DeBon tries to step through. Nothing there. Bodies everywhere. There goes Keats down the lane. My man Keats off the bench every time. He'll hurt you every time. Brett Keats, the junior, off the glass, man. Still up front is DeBon now. Another turnover here for Andover Central. Spin cycle by DeBon. Oh, just missed a tough one. Gets his own rebound. This is good. And they're extending that lead now. And great timeout by Central. That's a great timeout. Andover Central has four turnovers here, and we'll take a break with them here in the first quarter, 2:51, 10-5. The Raiders lead it. You're listening to, oh, it's the 52nd Ralph Miller Classic here Comet Vision.
Our Escape Coffee House is dedicated to high school and college students. Our mission is for every student in Southeast Kansas to know they have value, they are loved, and that they have a place. We are not a church, but we are motivated by the love God has for all of us. The Fire Escape opened in 1998 and is open every Friday and Saturday night for high school and college age students. During the week, the Fire Escape is open to the public Tuesday through Friday mornings for coffee, catch-ups, or small groups like Bible studies. The Fire Escape Coffee House is proud to partner with the Chanute High School Tech classes on this broadcast.
We're back here in Chanute, Kansas. You're on Comet Vision. 6-0 run right now by the Chanute Mission South Jaguars. They lead it 10-5. Good ball game here early. The Jaguars turned the ball over a few times here in a row. Coach had to draw something up. There's Brown with a long three. Oh, in and out. He already hit one here early. Just in and out. Good look. Just didn't fall for him. My man Keats now being guarded by Archibald. He'll set this offense up, get over to McKenna. McKenna looks inside to Kerrigan. Kerrigan being guarded by number 20. Kerrigan scores it. Great move by Kerrigan. He's had a great tournament. I didn't realize that. I should have told you guys that. Max Mason Metzke's in the ball game for the Jaguars. Brody for three. He knocks it down. Brody DeJarmo pulls a three out of his hip pocket. Cuts that lead to four. We got some subs coming in for the Raiders. Ben Allen checking in. Alongside Allen is Jacob Wood. Both of them been used sparingly in this tournament. And Ben Allen's done a great job this tournament. Whenever they called upon him, he's done a great job doing his job. There's Keats, a little pressure by Andover Central. Here's Allen. Gets to Kerrigan. Over Metzke. Basket's good. And Kerrigan's on one now. You know, another turnover for Andover Central. That's five. Ooh, tough layup and good. Jacob Wood there with that layup. Did a great job with the Euro step through. Avoided the charge. Penetration by Archibald. Gets a couple men in the air, and they're going to call it travel. And that's six turnovers now in this quarter for Andover Central. And they struggle with that a little bit. Checking the ball game now for the Raiders. Sauter. They're still putting that pressure on. It's an 8-point lead, largest lead of the ball game for the Raiders. Still putting that pressure on. There's Allen. Middle of the lane, he's going to keep it for himself. Oh, ho, ho. Off the wrong foot. Ben Allen went up off the wrong foot awkwardly and still was able to finish that off the glass. 10-point lead now, largest lead for the Raiders. They're putting the pressure on Central here early with a minute to go in the first quarter. I mean, they've sat down on the defensive end. Long three by Stupka. Rebound pulled down by Mishk. Long three by DeJarmo. He hit one already. He misses that one. Allen looking inside for Kerrigan. He's going to get doubled. Cross court pass. Great pass to Wood. Wood for three. Get you some, Wood. That's 5 points in this quarter. 13-point lead now for the Raiders. Wood came off the bench. Ready to play here. Down in his stance. There goes Archibald. Pass to Stupka. On the baseline. Tough layup. No good. Rebound Kerrigan. 10 seconds. Here comes Wood. He has already hit 1-3 in this quarter. 5 seconds. Wood tries to turn the corner. Pull up jumper. He's feeling himself. Oh, missed a tough one. And that's how we end the first quarter. And boy, the Raiders feeling it here early in this ballgame. They got a 13-point lead here at the Ralph Miller. We got more basketball coming for you. Ralph Miller Classic.
At Bridgewood Cabinetry, we believe in the power of transformation. Formerly known as Hilo Industries, our journey began right here in Chanute in 1974, where this community has been our heart and soul. We stand tall as a proud member and supporter of the Chanute community. Our success is a testament to the unwavering support of the people and businesses who live and work alongside us. Ridgewood is recognized as a technological leader in the wood products manufacturing industry, pushing boundaries every day. We are a family employing 275 dedicated individuals from Chanute and the surrounding areas, working together towards a common goal. Ridgewood provides high-quality cabinetry with cutting-edge style to over 500 kitchen and bath cabinet design studios in 48 states. This is where community and craftsmanship unite. Join us in creating spaces where memories are born and families come together. Ridgewood Cabinetry. Simple choices, endless possibilities.
The 52nd annual Ralph Miller Classic going on here in Chanute, Kansas. I am DJ Dangerfield. This is game one of day three for the Shawnee Mission South Raiders. We're taking on the Andover Central Jaguars. On the floor for the Jaguars right now is Jefferson, Brown, Archibald, Mishk, Adler on the floor, Wood, Sauter, Keach, Kerrigan, all on the floor, and Kerrigan with the block, all on the floor for Shawnee Mission South, man, and they are into it right now. Six turnovers in that first quarter for the Jaguars, for Andover Central. Here's Archibald working against Keach. Sauter chases him down, but he able to get rid of him. Look at Jadon Brown, man, great move there. And they just got to find a way to get a basket here. At all possible. A good cut. Ooh. Another turnover. Oh, spin cycle by Kerrigan off the glass. And good. Kerrigan has six here in the first half. Just a freshman, folks. You're watching a star in the making. Jalen Brown, and I mean the intensity of defense, they have just shut off this offense. They're like an 18-3 run by South. Over in the corners, Archibald. No good. Rebound, Sauter. Sauter goes to keep it. Looks up the floor. Central still in there, man-to-man. There's Ben Allen now with the ball. Going inside to Kerrigan, being guarded by Meske. Long three by Wood. He's already hit one off the mark. Battle by Sauter. Gets the offensive rebound and scores it. And a full timeout now. Being taken by Central. This one's getting away quickly. It's 6:37 to go in the half. It's 25-8. We got more basketball coming up here at the Ralph Miller Classic on Comet Vision.
Cardinal Drugstore, located at 103 East Main in downtown Chanute, is a small-town pharmacy and gift store which includes an old-fashioned soda fountain. They specialize in compounds and vaccines. They also supply many types of medical items. Cardinal Drugstore is your one-stop shop for all of your healthcare needs. KFEX and Comet Vision are so grateful for your support.
Back here in Chanute, Kansas, 52nd annual Ralph Miller Classic, 6:37 to go here in the first half. And boy, the South Raiders are raiding the place. They're on a 23-3 run right now. They lead it 25-8. And on the floor for the Raiders, you got Wood, you got Allen, you got Sauter, you got Keach, and you got Kerrigan. Now on the floor for Central, you got Jefferson, you got Brown. You got Archibald, you got Meske, you got Stupka. Central's wearing white, South is in their neon green. Boy, they have turned this into their gym. Trying to have a clean sweep here in the Ralph Miller at Shawnee Mission South. And I mean, they are guarding, do you hear me? They have turned the utilities off for Central. Penetration by Brown. Strong move over Wood. Off the mark, battle for the ball. Ben Allen comes away with it. And there's the freshman Kerrigan over to Wood now. Andover Central says in that man-to-man. Look how good South is working that offense. There's a good shooter there. He got second three-point contest. That's Sauter. He got second in the three-point contest today. Brown going to try to match him for a three here on the wing. Off the mark. Brown already has one. He's one for three now. 5:45 to go in the half. Here come most of the starters for South now. Getting ready to check in. Keats on the baseline. Oh, good job by Archibald on defense. No call. Great job. Loose ball scrum here. And we're going to have a foul called. Looks like it's going to be called on Kerrigan. And first team foul for South. It was on Kerrigan, his first wholesale subs coming in. So you got Devon. You got my man Gregory coming back in. You got Featherston coming in. And you got Max McKenna checking in. Alongside Wood here. And then you got Brody DeJarmo coming back in the ball game for Central. He's going to penetrate. There's going to be a foul on the up front there. Balk is also checked in for Central. We saw him a few times this tournament. See if he can't get open for a shot. The Raiders have just been playing great defense here. Brody DeJarmo under great help by Devon. Stretches the defense. Long three by Jace Jefferson, the junior. And that was a long needed basket there. Now 14. That was a very much needed basket. Over the top to Devon. He does catch it. A little hook shot over the middle, and he knocks it down. And that's just what he does, folks. He has six. Ooh, spin move by Stupka. Goes up strong on Wood. That is a foul. A little body there by Wood. Third team foul. Brad Stupka. Andover's two for two from the free throw line tonight. 13 foul for the Raiders. Jace Adler made both the free throws for him early. Stupka knocks that one down. He makes both of them there. He now has two. That's his first two of the game. And turnover for the Raiders. That's their second one of the half. The starters come in, struggle a little bit. They maybe sat there a little too long. Bench players is balling out here. 4:30 here in the half. There you go. Oh, it looks partially blocked by McKenna. Ball tried to get a three there, and there's McKenna off the glass and good. He has four now, 16-point lead for the Raiders. There's Brody moving and working there. He's being guarded by Gregory. He's going to get it over to Meske. Great soft touch by Mason Meske, the junior. Caught it there on the short corner. Over to Bond, knocks it down on the baseline there in the short corner. Great soft touch there by Meske. Bond wanting the ball. They're going to get over to Featherston for three. He got third place in the three-point shooting contest. He's 0 for 2 today now from down there. Long three by Jefferson off the mark. Great hustle by Brody. DeJarmo unable to save it, though. Man-to-man defense by Central. There goes Devon. He was tapped on the arm on his way to the basket. Right, he's going up for the shot. He's going to shoot two. Devon has six, making his first trip to the line.
Foul call on Mason Meske. This first personal foul. First team foul on the Jaguars.
What a tournament this young man's had. This kid is playing phenomenal basketball. And Allen comes in for Wood. Good minutes by Wood there. Ben Allen's going to check it for him. Man, Wood was out there balling. DeBond's second free throw off the mark. Here comes Central. inside to Adler. Adler fakes, gives it up to DeJarmo. DeJarmo misses on the front end. Got a jump ball between Allen and DeJarmo. DeJarmo missed an easy chip shot there on the front end. And Archibald's now going to check in. He's coming in for Stupka. And we got a time on the floor, and it'll be the Shawnee Mission South Raiders taking their timeout. We'll take one with them with 3:08 to go here in the half. Shawnee Mission South leads it 29-15 against Andover Central here. Ralph Miller on Comet Vision.
From kickoff to the final lap, from peewees to the weekend pros, our team of doctors can help with the diagnosis and treatment of sports-related injuries. Wherever you are in your sports journey, Labette Health Sports Medicine Team has the training, experience, and skill to repair, restore, and renew. For more information about Southeast Kansas' leading orthopedic and sports medicine program, go to labettehealth.com.
We're back here, 3:08 to go in the half. Shawnee Mission South leads it 29-15 against Andover Central. On the floor for South, DeBon, Gregory, Allen, McKenna, Featherston. On the floor for Central, Balk, Jefferson, DeGarmo, Adler, and Archibald. Shawnee Mission South in neon green, Andover Central in the white. Looking inside, that time was Featherston. That'll be a turnover. They're trying to get the ball to DeBon. I'm sure that's what the coach drew up. Third turnover here in the half. Adler battling down low. They're going to call a hold down low on Gregory. Trying to get the ball inside to Adler. Call a hold on Gregory there. Second team foul. Fourth team foul. So next shot, next foul, and Andover Central will be shooting. And Kerrigan comes in for DeBon. Central runs their play. Great cut by Adler. Can he finish over the top of Kerrigan? Turn around off the left hand, and it's just off the mark. Rebounded by Allen. Great job by Kerrigan and not fouling there. Here's McKenna on the baseline. Great strong move. Some contact. No call. Here comes Balk. Ooh, over Archibald. He might have traveled there. Might have traveled twice. There's Balk with a three off the mark. Balk didn't like that from the time he shot it. He shot it and took off after it. Oh, we got ball everywhere. We got people everywhere here now. I mean, it's loose balls everywhere. We got a jump ball. It's a little out of control there. McKenna's going to sub out for Keach. Brett Keach is going to check in. He's been a spark off the bench. And checking for the Jaguars is going to be Brown for Archibald. Coach wanted one more ball handler out there for Central. 2:10 to go here in the half. It's 29-15. Shawnee Mission South leads this ball game. They're playing man. Both teams been a man-to-man all afternoon. Look at Allen locking down on Brown. A great cut by Adler, though. He's going to be fouled by Keach. Great awareness on that cut by Adler. Great entry pass by DeJarmo under pressure. He's going to shoot two. Got to be Brett Keach's first person off the bench. And we're in a little scoring lull here. Adler, he's 2 for 2, now 3 for 3 from the free throw line. Sauter just checked in for Gregory. Archibald just came in for Balk. For Central. Adler misses one there. That might have been my fault there, Adler. Here's Allen coming down the floor quickly. Been a while since Shawnee Mission South has got a basket. Let's see what they can do here. 1:45 to go in the half. It's 29-16. Allen at the top. Ooh, great pass to Kerrigan on the inside from Sauter, who just missed it. Gets his own rebound and puts it up and in. Kerrigan looked like he's just a freshman, but he looked like a grown man down there right now. Ooh, great hop step by Archibald. It's going to be blocked by Sauter. There's a turnover. Brown thought about it. Pulls up. Ooh, tough shot. Just missed. And battling down low. Adler gets the offensive rebound. Down low fighting. He has 5 here in this half, and it's a 13-point game. Central slowly but surely trying to creep back in. up front there. Jefferson being fouled by Sauter. Sauter, great penetration, being strong. Kid, you watch that. He catches it. He pivots it. Pivots with it. Stays strong with the basketball. And the guy's up on you. Try to go by him. He's able to draw a foul. Great textbook basketball there by Sauter. Meschke comes back in. He comes in for Jefferson. Jefferson has three fouls now. There's Sauter looking inside for Keach. Keach being guarded by Meschke. Kicks out to Allen. Allen goes inside to Kerrigan. Kerrigan with a great post. Try to finish with the left hand. No good. Meschke ends up getting in that scrum. Here comes DeJarmo. This is a big possession here for Andover Central before the half ends. Big possession here. Brody DeJarmo. Will spin. Brown for three. He needs this one. Oh, just in and out. Oh, man. Unkind rim down there. That's twice now for Brown. Got a weird spin on the basketball and was unable to knock it down. Now we're down to 15 seconds. What you don't want is for the – if you're a Central fan, you do not want the Raiders to score on this possession. Here's Keats, though. Keats knows how to do it. Allen, he penetrates. Look at Archibald playing hard. Archibald trying to – just being a pest down there. Under 5 seconds here now. They inbound the ball underneath their own basket. Here's Sauter. There he is. Over to Keach. Keach gets great penetration off the glass. Ooh, nice try by Kerrigan. Just missed it. And that's how we'll end this half. And boy, Andover Central digging back in. And a chance for Shawnee Mission to extend the lead in that second half. Andover Central was able to dig back in, dig their heels. And folks, this could end up being a pretty good ball game. So you're going to stay locked here. It's the 52nd annual Ralph Miller Classic. This is game one. That's the end of the first half. We've got some more great basketball coming up for you, so you stay here. I'm DJ Dangerfield. Got more coming up here on Comet Vision.
The Medicine Shop Pharmacy, located right across the street from Royster Middle School in downtown Chanute, is in the business of making you feel better, faster. With three licensed pharmacists, the Medicine Shop has the knowledge to know the right drugs and the proper dosage to ensure your safety. If you're not quite up to your game, Medicine Shop offers delivery to your door. The Medicine Shop, a proud underwriter of the Chanute Blue Comets.
Sparklight is unveiling unlimited internet for just $25 a month. Get reliable 100 meg internet for just $25 a month for 12 months with unlimited data. That's unlimited internet. Call 877-469-3057 or visit sparklight.com/savings. Sparklight, a new breed and high speed.
Home Savings Bank is a platinum underwriter here at the Fire Escape Coffee House. Home Savings Bank has been serving the Chanute area since 1886. Customer owned and customer driven, Home Savings Bank, located at 214 North Lincoln Avenue in Chanute, Kansas, is here to serve all your banking needs. Whether your needs are checking, savings account, safety deposit box, lending, or online banking, Home Savings Bank is here to help. Home Savings Bank is located on the internet at homesavingschanute.com. Home Savings Bank is committed to the youth of Southeast Kansas and helping the ministries at the Fire Escape Coffee House.
Well, we're back here in Chanute, Kansas, the 52nd annual Ralph Miller Classic. Game one here on day three in Shawnee Mission South Raiders. Trying to put this thing away here. They have a chance to do a clean sweep here. They lead it 31-18 to the Andover Central Jaguars. Until the half really came down to just some key plays and turnovers. I mean, once Shawnee Mission South put the pressure on, they defensively, I'm talking about they came down and got stops. And when they went on that run, they went on like a 20 to 3 run, give or take. And I mean, it just turned everything off. Now, in that second quarter, saw some good stuff happen with Andover Central. Let's see if they can keep that going. So we got Sonder, we got Gregory, Kerrigan, Featherston, McKinn on the floor. Now, DeBon, like he hurt his ankle. So we may not see him the rest of this game. DeBon looked like he hurt his ankle earlier, so he may, coaches may leave him out. Kerrigan's having a great tournament. Gregory off the glass. Oh, just missed it. Here comes Brown. Up the floor. He turns it over. He had the right idea. He's unable to make that pass. You'll see Brown do that from time to time. Featherston now, cross-court pass and possible turnover here. Great hustle by Stupka. They're going to call a foul on Sonder here up front. Great hustle by Stupka. Able to get to that loose ball. He's got something going on with his hand. Maybe a quick sub for him. That'll be Archibald coming in for him now. It's a little contact there. Did he dislocate his hand, a finger? Maybe I have to put that booger back in place. I don't want to watch that. You don't like all that yanking and pulling and carrying on. I don't want to see all that. 7:25 in the third quarter. This is a key. How you get started in the third quarter is key to coming back in this ball game. Andover Central looking for good possession here. Here's Brody. He's being guarded by Gregory. Andover Central wearing their white jerseys with the little black and tan. Shawnee Mission South is the one in the neon green. Inside now to Adler. He's going to kick it out pretty quick. Brown with the penetration. He's got some trouble there with Sauter. He's in the lands of the Giants down there. Look at the patience of Andover Central. Brody Jarmo, turnaround. Just missed it. Rebound by Sauter. Sauter does a great job rebounding the ball. He then pivots out of the pressure. He does a good job of controlling the basketball and bringing it up. Sauter just a solid ball player, a good all-around ball player. Here's Featherston. He got third in the three-point shootout. And he hits his first three, and he's capable of doing that. He's hit at least three of them in this tournament. Featherston has had 6 and 7 points in the tournament. Ooh, nice move by Brown, just unable to finish. Great move, just didn't finish it. There's Featherston again. I thought maybe he'd do a heat check. Showing great discipline. They go inside to Kerrigan. Kerrigan had 8 in the first half. Really good first half for him, the freshman. He's going to get a little more time today because DeBon is nursing an ankle over there. And Adler picks up his third, so they're bringing Meske here early. Probably a little quicker than what coach wanted to. And there's Featherston with another three, and he hits it again. Back-to-back threes by Featherston. He got third in the three-point shootout. He's letting it fly and extends the lead to 19 now. Shawnee Mission South. There's Meske. Archibald. Can call a foul there. Looks like on Featherston. That'll be his third. Both teams have 2 team fouls here so far in this second half, so far in this third quarter. Going to go to Brody DeJarmo. He's being guarded by Gregory. Right up front here. Brown now. He's had a couple possessions where he's got some good penetration and is unable to come away with anything. Brown from downtown hits that three. That's his second one of the game. He's had a couple of them rim out. We got timeout on the floor. It's going to be a 30-second timeout for Andover Central. We'll take a 30-second timeout. We'll be right back with more basketball here at the Ralph Miller on Comet Vision.
At Human Touch at your bank, at Community National Bank and Trust, you'll be able to talk with a real person. Community National Bank is small enough to know you, yet big enough to offer the best products. Your busy lifestyle requires banking options like mobile deposit and people-to-people pay. With locations in Southeast Kansas and Southwest Missouri, Community National Bank and Trust can help keep your finances safe and your spending smarter. Online at mybankcnb.com. Community National Bank and Trust. Federally insured. Locally awesome. Member FDIC.
Back here in Chanute, the 52nd annual Ralph Miller Classic. I'm DJ Dangerfield. Got the Shawnee Mission South Raiders taking on the Andover Central Jaguars. Right now, Shawnee Mission South leads it by 16. On the floor for the Jaguars are Brown and DeJarmo and Archibald and Meske. And Jefferson on the floor for Shawnee Mission South, Sauter, McKenna, Gregory, Featherston, and Kerrigan. That's what you're going to watch, this Kerrigan and this Meske matchup down low. Kerrigan's the one setting the screen there for McKenna. Now they got a mismatch with Archibald and Kerrigan. Kerrigan, easy shot, easy finish. He's now in double digits. He has 10. Kerrigan had 13 last night. He had 6 in the first game. He's got 10 tonight. Ooh, great block by Sauter. He's long. Athletic. Jefferson should throw up a little bit higher. Sauter got second in the three-point shootout. He can shoot the three. He hasn't shot the ball like he normally can in this tournament. Really good shooter. There's Brown again. Brown working against Featherston again. McKenna comes over and gets the block. And they say a little foul there. Oh, man, that's good stuff right there. Brown's going to go to the line. That's on McKenna. That's one. I'm being good today. I'm not saying anything about the officials. I'm going to be good today. No comment. You saw it, folks. You saw the call. Free throws up, and that's good by Andover. I love the heart of this young man at the free throw line. Jacob Wood checks in for South. He comes in for Featherston. Featherston's got 3 also. Jaden Brown makes more of them. There's some key pieces to Jaden Brown's game that he's going to need to add to be that dude. But the one thing that, and he can learn those things. One thing you can't teach kids is heart. He has heart. A couple pieces he's got to add to his game. And he's going to be something special. Sauter working down low, out to McKenna. Sauter for 3. He can do that. Oh, he's just been unable to knock it down here in the game. But it's picked up by my man Gregory. He gets his first 2 of this ball game. 18-point lead now for Shawnee Mission South. Brody DeJarmo, tough shot over Gregory. And Gregory got some elbows, some forearm. I told you DeJarmo's a tough kid, this dude. This dude's a tough dude. Gregory, he got too close, man. Too close. He got a little bit of everything. Got a little forearm, elbow, maybe a pinky in the face. DeJarmo knocks down the free throw. His first free throw of the night. He made 1 3 earlier. Early in the first quarter, he made a 3. His second free throw is good. He has 5. Back to 16 now. 4:10 to go here in the third. Here's Wood. Came out in the second quarter. Guns blazing. To McKenna for 3. Bam! Good job. And there's a Sauter with the pass. McKenna stepped into it. He now has 7. Boy, McKenna's put together a good tournament. Very first game against Piper, only had 2. Came out and scored 20. He has 7 tonight. Inside to Archibald, over Sauter, and it's just, he didn't have a chance. I mean, Archibald just didn't have a chance. 19-point lead, largest lead now for South, and Ben Allen comes in the ball game. Keats comes in the ball game. And these are the guys that really extended that lead. Allen and Keach, Wood are ones who extended that lead there in the second quarter. Look at Allen going to the lane and call a block. Allen saw an opportunity to call a foul on Jefferson.
Ben Allen to the line to shoot two.
Shooting his first free throws here. 13 foul for Andover Central. That's four there on Jefferson. He just hasn't been able to get going defensively. A little bit behind all night. First free throw by Allen is good. And that's been the one part of Shawnee's game, Shawnee Mission's game here. They're shooting 500. They're 3-for-6 as a team. Adler comes in now for Jefferson. Now 3-for-7. That's been the one part of their game that hasn't been well today. Shawnee Mission's out trying to get first place in this tournament. Oh, great block. I mean, looked like Jace Adler had an easy basket there. And it was blocked from behind, and then they come down the floor, and Keach scores it. Must be a warning there, letting the ball. Ethan Balky back in now the ball game. He comes in for Brody DeJarmo. Three 3:10 to go. 18-point lead by Shawnee Mission South here. They're going into 1-1-3 zone. Wood picking him up, picking up Brown here. Going to see what this zone offense for Andover Central. And you're going to penetrate the gaps, find somebody in the middle of the floor, and step into a three if you can. Your three you're looking for is going to come off penetration. Try to get that ball in the middle if you can. There it is. There's Adler there. There he was there, a little late. Brown for three. Tough three. Tough three. And he has eight in this half. 11 in the game. Man-to-man for Central here. There's Sauter. Allen. Almost a turnover. A little double there and call a foul on Archibald. Nice double there in the corner. Fourth team foul for Andover Central. And I don't know, that might be four for Archibald, too. DeGarmo's going to come in. It's his first for Archibald. DeGarmo's going to come back in for Balky. Here's Allen now going against Archibald. Archibald active on the defensive end. Great job. Central that time, turnover. Tough layup. No call. Bodies were everywhere. Archibald, the finish. South second turnover of this half. They got six in the game. Kerrigan will come in for Sauter. Sauter's also limping now. DeBon is over here. Like he's limping, and now Sauter's limping to that play. There's Wood. There's Keach now. Central extending this defense a little bit. See, 17-point lead, trying to dig into that lead. Going to try to get another turnover here if you can. Keach with the penetration. Out to Wood. He's already hit one today. Off the mark, rebounded by Adler. Spin move by DeJarmo. Nothing there. Great defense. Brown with the three, though. Boy, rimmed out again. That's happened to him several times tonight. Keach cruising down. But look at Archibald. Archibald's done a great job defensively. He stays very active. Active hands. Moves his feet. Plays tough. There's DeJarmo for three. Good. DeGarmo for three. And he has eight. That's his second three of the night. And we got a timeout on the floor. Shawnee Mission South and a 14-point lead. And we're going to take a 30-second timeout with them. With 55 seconds to go here in the third quarter, Shawnee Mission South up by 14. 52nd annual Ralph Miller Classic here on Comet Vision.
Hey,
KFEX Fire Escape Radio programming is made possible in part by the underwriting efforts of Sonic Drive-In of Chanute. Sonic Drive-In of Chanute does not consider community involvement a sales gimmick or a public relations ploy. They see it as a way to be a good neighbor and as a way to have a positive impact on their community. It is for these reasons that Sonic Drive-In of Chanute is a proud underwriter of KFEX Fire Escape Radio and the ministry efforts of the entire Fire Escape Ministry to the youth of Chanute.
We're back here in Chanute, being entertained by the Shawnee Mission South Cheer Squad. So cool. They travel deep, man. They travel deep over there. It's like 20 young ladies over there cheering on the squad. That's just cool. Getting ready for this second game coming up with your Chanute Blue Comets. We'll take on the Piper Pirates for third place here in this tournament. Andover Central just not going away. The Jaguars just not going away here. Cut the lead to 14 at one point in time, being down by 21. Cut back into that lead now with 55 seconds to go on the third. On the floor for Shawnee Mission South, Keach, Wood, McKenna, Allen, Kerrigan. On the floor for the Jaguars, Brown, Meschke, DeJarmo, Archibald, Nadler. Trap over there, but they're able to come away with it. There goes Wood. Almost turned over. Great job. I'm telling you, this Archibald kid, active hands, active feet, anticipating on defense. Archibald's been a spark here in this third quarter defensively. Brown's going to get a break now as Balky comes in for Central. Here's Kerrigan. Oh, there's Keach, excuse me. Over to Allen for three. And he knocks it down. Wow. And that's six for him, and my goodness, just they have all kinds of sparks on this Shawnee Mission South team. Man. Balky being guarded by McKenna here, and Shawnee Mission South went back to their man-to-man. The five-second count is on. 5 seconds to go here in the quarter. Penetration by DeGarmo. Out to Balky, and he's been waiting for that one. He shot a couple of them, was unable to hit. He was able to hit that one, so it's going to be 14 now. Shawnee Mission South is up 50-36, up by 14 here going into the fourth quarter. Stay here. We got some more action here. 50-second now, Ralph Miller contest here on CommaVision. Off this fourth quarter here in Chanute, Kansas, the 52nd annual Ralph Miller Classic going on. Shawnee Mission South trying to get away with first place here in a clean sweep. They're up by 14 here to Andover Central Jaguars. On the floor for Shawnee Mission South right now is Gregory, Keach, McKenna, Allen, Kerrigan. On the floor for Andover is Brown, Balky, Adler, Archibald, Meschke. If you just now tuned in, Andover Central's in white. The Raiders, Shawnee Mission South, neon green. Oh, back-to-back threes there for Balky in the corner. Didn't knock it down, but the offensive rebound by Archibald. He's doing it all. Archibald out there balling today. Here's Adler. Jump stop almost goes down. They're going to call it travel there. Only the second turnover of the half. They had seven turnovers in the first half. They only had two so far in this half, nine for the game. So they tightened it up. They did the same thing in the first half last night. They had seven turnovers in the first half last night at Andover Central. They've tightened it up here in the second half. And Andover Central going to stay in there man-to-man, and they're going to have to, at some point in time, they're going to have to get themselves some extra possessions here. McKenna out to Gregory. Great penetration by Gregory. Great shot, unable to knock it down. Rebound Adler. Here comes Brown on the break. 3-on-3. Brown keeps it. Draws some contact on McKenna. He's going back to the line. And he had 8 in the third quarter, did Brown. He made a couple of threes in that quarter. Brown drawing some contact on McKenna.
Max McKenna, his second.
Love this kid's heart. He can play the game. McKenna gets his second. Brown's first free throw is good. And Brody DeGarmo comes in the ball game for Balky. Cut this thing now to 12 if he hits this. And right now, the Jaguars are 9 for 10 from the line. I don't think young people really realize how making free throws can keep, even if you're not playing well, if you make free throws, it can keep you in a game. Meske down there battling with Kerrigan. Oh, man, they're going to call a charge there on McKenna. Great job by DeGarmo. DeGarmo flying around out there. Drew a charge on McKenna, and that's 3 now for McKenna. Sauter and Featherston check back in for Shawnee Mission South. They're going to get McKenna and Allen. 12-point game, and they're trying to get this under 10. There goes Brown down the lane, off the glass and good. Brown's got 12 in the half. 15 in the game. It's now a 10-point lead. At one point, it was 21. And Andover Central picking up full court here. Ooh, trouble in the heels here. Adler on Sauter. Meske. Oh, got a foul called up front here. Oh, boy. And the intensity is picking up here. Andover Central just not going away. Adler's fourth foul, though. We got to keep an eye on that. Adler, a very important piece to Andover Central. Here comes Gregory. Over to Keach. Boy, this is a ball game here, folks. There's Gregory, the coach on the floor, Gregory. Look at that, I tell you. Gregory is a coach on the floor. He is a facilitator. He's a point guard classic. You just don't see point guards like this anymore. A lot of the point guards, they look at shot first. This Gregory kid facilitates his offense very well. There's Featherston with a tough shot. Wow, Featherston with a tough shot. Extends the lead to 12, 5:58 to go here in the ball game. Seeing Shawnee Mission South trying to get the passing. There's Brown, though. Ooh. Ooh, ooh, ooh. Archibald. Great defense by Featherston. Great defense there. There's this Garmo. He's going to get it to the Archibald. Look at Featherston sit down here. Great D. Shot by Adler. Off the mark. Gets his own rebound out to Archibald. Archibald baselines it to Adler. Adler, tough side. Left-handed. No good. Battle for the board. Who's going to come away with it? Of course, it's Archibald on the floor. And they come away with it. Brown for a D3. He was fouled and just missed it. And that time is going to be Keats trying to get out to the shooter. And sometimes you forget as a shooter. Sometimes you just close out. You just close out is all you need. The old school close out. You get so desperate you can foul a three-point shooter. And Brown's going back to the line. He's 4 for 4 tonight. Boy, it's been the free throws that's kept Andover in this ball game for sure.
3 team fouls for the Raiders.
Ice in his veins is Brown. Chance to cut this thing to 9. We haven't seen this since the first quarter. We haven't been here since the first quarter, folks. Balky just checked back in for Archibald on Andover Central. They are 11 for 13 now. Timeout on the floor. We'll take a 30-second timeout, too. It's 50-second down and Rapid Miller Classic here on Comet Vision. 30-second timeout.
For years, Jared Gilmore and Phillips PA has been providing quality financial guidance to local individuals and businesses. Their expertise ranges from basic tax management and accounting services to more in-depth services such as audits, financial statements, QuickBooks support, and payroll. Jared Gilmore and Phillips PA has backed Chanute's youth in all their endeavors from the classroom to extracurricular activities. They're proud to help support the youth of Chanute by underwriting this KFEX broadcast.
Back here in Chanute, Kansas, we got a business is picking up. Business is picking up. Andover Central on a little run here. Only 2 points scored in this quarter by Shawnee Mission South. And with that in mind, Andover Central's cut the lead to 9. Behind 15 in this half from Jaden Brown. He's got 18 in the game. Jaden Brown has put his team on his back. And then defensively, this team has played really well defensively here in the second half as Andover Central. You can't help but be proud as a coach. You can't help but be proud as a coach. Got a foul here up front. It's going to be on Jaden Brown. It's going to be the second team foul. Well, third team foul, excuse me. It's going to be Jaden Brown's third. The pressure, Andover Central's pressure in this ball. 5 minutes to go in this ball game. 9-point lead. Andover Central's trying to figure it out. Brown and Gregory getting on here up front. Keats trapped over there in the corner. He's in trouble. He's able to get out of it. Another trap. Man, if Brown's a little bit taller. There's Kerrigan. Nice move on Meske. Off the glass. No good. Gets his own rebound. He does that really well. When Kerrigan misses, he does a good job of getting his own rebound. He has 12 tonight. And a turnover here. And Keach also turns it over. So one good turnover deserves another there. 11-point ball game here, 4:20 to go. Here's Brown being guarded by Keach. Over to Balky. Here's Adler at the top. He's being guarded by Kerrigan. They've been battling down low every possession. And over Central looking for a shot somebody can step into. DeGarmo. Tough move over Featherston. He gets it, though. DeGarmo comes up big there, and he has 10 now. Back to 9. DeBon is on the bench. DeBon's on the bench. He has a bad ankle. They could use him now. There's Featherston penetrating by Meske. Over Meske. Tough shot. Good. And Featherston. Been the bright spot here in the fourth quarter. He has 5 in this half. 13 in the game, and Featherston's come up big here in this ball game tonight. Ooh, tipped by Kerrigan. He's on the break. Oh, great job by Balky not giving up on the play. Good job by Balky not giving up on that play, able to get that ball knocked out of bounds. That's 4 turnovers now for Andover Central. 11 for the game. 4 turnovers in this half, 11 for the game. Brown sits down and Archibald comes out. Brown's going to get a break here with 3:07 to go. It's 11-point lead for Shawnee Mission South. There's McKenna now, capable scorer. Looking for Kerrigan. Great cut by Featherston. Look at Gregory, man. Foul and 1. I told you he's the coach on the floor. PG Classic right there is what I – PG Classic. You look up classic point guard in the dictionary, you're going to see Gregory's face. Plays the game the right way. 13-point lead. Just plays the game the right way. He steps up and knocks down the free throw for his team. Extends this lead to 14. I tell you, folks, tell you what, nothing like having a coach on the floor. Meske has a seat. They bring in Balky. He's going to bring in some shooters. DeGarmo gets penetration. Oh, somehow stays with it, and somehow Aller ends up getting that ball. I have no clue how. 12-point lead now, 2:40 to go. McKenna's going to hold it. He's getting guarded by Balky. Balky gets a steal up front. Oh. The foul was on. That was a late call. Yeah, that's tough. Nevertheless, McKenna's going to shoot two here. McKenna's been kind of quiet tonight. Yeah, seven. Quiet night for him. Sophomore. Knocks down the free throw. His first free throw tonight. That'll give him eight for the game. I told you I'm not. You try to bait me with the instant replay, you guys. You give me to talk about the officials. I'm not doing it. I'm not doing it today. I'm not falling for those little tricks, kids. Trying to bait me. There goes DeGarmo now, working against Gregory. Great matchup there. Rebounded by Kerrigan. He looked like he was pushed by Archibald. No call. There goes Sauter. Intensity. Picking up 14-point lead. Andover Central wants the ball back. Featherston. Great move. Gets his own rebound. Unable to knock it down. Featherston has 13 tonight. He felt that. Here comes Allen. And Featherston's going to come out for Allen. Coach is going to have a conversation with him and asking him why. That's probably what he's asking, why. Archibald comes out and Brown comes back in. Randover Central, that clock is tick, 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 tick. They're going to have to figure this out. Coming to the two-minute warning here. Brown penetrates. They got to get some shots up now. There's Jefferson. He thought about it. There's DeGarmo. He knew it. Ooh, just missed. McKinnon with the rebound. Adler's got four. He doesn't want to foul. Here's Kerrigan now. Up the floor to Allen. Allen off the glass. Good. Boy, what a game he's had tonight. He's got eight now. Here goes Brown. A little contact there. No call. They're going to call it travel. I don't know. That's tough. Sauter, the foul will be on Jefferson, and I think that'll be it for him. Great job here by Shawnee Mission South. They weathered the storm. It was cut to nine. Shawnee Mission weathered the storm. That will be five on Jefferson. Jefferson's had a tough night defensively. He fouls out tonight. Jefferson does with 3 points. Just couldn't get going tonight. He had 7 and 7 in both of his games, and he had 3 tonight. There's Sauter. He knocks out a free throw. His first score, his first points of the half. He has 3 now. He got second in the 3-point shooting contest. He can shoot the 3, just unable to translate during the actual game for him. He knocks down both of those. That gives him 4. That's going to bring Wood in now for Gregory. Mixed into 18-point lead, and we're going to have a timeout on the floor. We'll stay here. 1:29 to go in the fourth quarter. Shawnee Mission South is up by 18. I tell you what, Jaden Brown has 18 in this game, and he was doing the best he could to bring his team back tonight, doing everything he could to bring his team back tonight. But just too much on Shawnee Mission South of things. Man, just too much. So many different players here. That team effort. But really, Featherston here in this fourth quarter and Gregory, the two guards here, have done a great job making sure that they get that first place here in the 52nd annual Ralph Miller Classic. Great ball game tonight. And I tell you what, Jordan Duncan won the 3-point shooting contest today, and he is the back-to-back champ. Phenomenal three-point shooter he is. He went ahead and walked it back home, walked that trophy back home. Wins it back-to-back. Good stuff there. Jaden Sutter for Shawnee Mission South got second, and Brody Featherston for Shawnee Mission South got third. All three kids, really good kids. We get ready to wrap up this ball game here. 1:29 to go in the fourth quarter. Shawnee Mission South up by 18. against Andover Central. Andover's going to be throwing the ball in, going full court here. They're wearing white. On the floor for Andover is DeJarmo, Brown, Balky, Adler, and Archibald. DeJarmo now penetrates middle of the lane. Gets it over to Adler for a little baseline 10-footer, and they're going to call a foul there on Allen. Little push. He's trying to reach around Archibald to get the ball. All right, we got some subs coming in. Okay, we got Matthew Burns, Thomas Burns, I'll do the best I can, folks. I can't see who the next guy is. Long three by Brown, just off the mark. Rebound, Allen. Battling. Going to call a foul. On the floor right now. Oh, and Luke Hampton. That's who came in. Luke, you got Luke Hampton. You got, I'm assuming, the Burns brothers out there. Thomas Burns. Matthew Burns. You got Allen out there. You got Wood out there. Shawnee Mission South. And then for Andover, you got Adler. You got Balky. You got Archibald. You got Brown. You got DeGarmo. Archibald picks up his third foul. 109 to go here. 18-point lead. Tip of the hat to Shawnee Mission South. This has been a great tournament. None of these games have been easy for them. But down the stretch, this team has done the right thing. They're 8 for 13 from the free throw line, though. That's what's different. Number 20 now checking in for Andover Central, Meske. Also coming in, number 11, Carter Inslee. And also coming in, Cal Schultz for Andover Central. Some names. Coaches letting some other guys get in this ball game. Good job by both coaches there. Making this a full experience for everyone. And Allen knocks down his free throw here. He's 2 for 4 from the line there. Long three by Balky, no good. Battle. Secured by number 25, Thomas Burns. He's going to bring it up. 49 seconds. 19-point lead here for Shawnee Mission South. Team from up north. Wood with the penetration. He has 7, and he came on in that second. He's a big reason why they won this ball game, believe it or not. Wood is off the bench. He came in off the bench and made a great run in that second quarter to extend this lead. And that's how we're in this ball game. Tip of the hat to Shawnee Mission South. I've enjoyed watching these young men play. If you're a friend or a parent of these young men, be proud. They play the game the right way. Same for Andover Central. Andover Central doesn't get a win in this tournament, but you, as a coach, there's still a lot you can be proud of with these young men, too. So that's how we'll end. Tip of the hat to Shawnee Mission South Raiders, and they'll be your 52nd annual Ralph Miller Classic champions here tonight. They'll be the first place. So we got third place coming up between the Chanute Blue Comets, the Piper Pirates. Good job to the team. This will close up this broadcast. 52nd annual Ralph Miller Classic here on Comet Vision.
Whether you're completing home repairs, weekend projects, or planning your garden for spring, Cleaver Farm and Home, 2103 South Santa Fe, has a carefully selected inventory for all of your paint, hardware, and building needs. Cleaver's also offers free delivery for cat and dog food if ordered online at www.cleaverfarm.com. Cleaver supports the youth outreach of the Fire Escape Youth Ministry and is happy to underwrite KFEX Radio. Thank you, Cleaver family. We appreciate your support. Missing that human touch at your bank? At Community National Bank and Trust, you'll be able to talk with a real person. Community National Bank is small enough to know you, yet big enough to offer the best products. Your busy lifestyle requires banking options like mobile deposit and people-to-people pay. With locations in Southeast Kansas and Southwest Missouri, Community National Bank and Trust can help keep your finances safe and your spending smarter. Online at mybankcnb.com. Community National Bank and Trust. Federally insured. Locally awesome. Member FDIC.
Home Savings Bank is a platinum underwriter here at the Fire Escape Conference. Home Savings Bank has been serving the Chanute area area since 1886. Customer-owned and customer-driven, Home Savings Bank, located at 214 North Lincoln Avenue in Chanute, Kansas, is here to serve all your banking needs. Whether your needs are checking, savings account, safety deposit box, lending, or online banking, Home Savings Bank is here to help. Home Savings Bank is located on the internet at homesavingschanute.com. Home Savings Bank is committed to the youth of Southeast Kansas and helping the ministries at the Fire Escape Coffee House.
Coming up, our matchup between Casey Piper and your very own Chanute Blue Comets. Coming up next,
thank you.
but the FBLA Spirit Store with Ralph Miller here will be closing during the second quarter of this game. So if you need your Ralph Miller gear, we have t-shirts for $10, crews for $17, and hoodies for $22 out of the Spirit Store, the Chanute FBLA Spirit Store out in the Commons area. Get them while they last. The store closes during the second quarter of this last game. Also, just a reminder, when you buy tickets, we have Hoops for Cash. So Hoops for Cash, those tickets will be drawn between the first and second quarter. So get your tickets at the concession stand, the Chanute Foreign Language Club, CHS Foreign Language Club, selling tickets, Hoops for Cash. And that will take place during halftime of the game.
Thank you.
to invite you and welcome to the sixth game of our Ralph Miller Classic 2024. Our game between our very own Chanute Blue Comets. And they'll take on the Casey Piper Pirates. Just a reminder, this contest is being played under the authority of the Kansas State High School Activities Association, whose rules provide for fair play and good sportsmanship among athletes and coaches, respect for the officials, players, and coaches, and respect for the host facilities are expected and essential for the success of this game. We encourage you as fans and spectators to applaud fair play, respect the rights of those around you, and to promote only the highest ideals of good sportsmanship. In accordance with the Kansas State Fire Marshal, we request you take a moment to recognize the emergency exits closest to you. A reminder, the use of tobacco products within our buildings belonging to Chanute USD 413 is strictly prohibited. We thank you for your cooperation in upholding our policy. And now, if you please stand, face the flag, and place your hand over your heart for the playing of our national anthem.
Afternoon, ladies and gentlemen.
Piper Pirates.
This is the third place game of the Ralph Miller Classic here.
Starting off for Casey Piper, a 5'11" junior.
Yeah, that's better. This is the third place game here at the Ralph Miller Classic. I am DJ Dangerfield. So glad you are here with me. We just saw the first place game played for the most part by Shawnee Mission South. They come away with the victory on today, and they'll take first place here in the 2024 Ralph Miller Classic. And now your beloved Blue Comets are taking on the Piper Pirates, also out of Kansas City, getting it on against the Blue Comets today. And some of your starters here for this ball game, starting for the Pirates first, is number one, Lance Walton. Boy, he's put together a really good tournament. Double digits both games he's played in. P.J. Moore, also starting for the Pirates. He's put together a good tournament. Devin Kerr, the 6'6 senior. He's having a really good tournament also. He'll be starting for the Pirates. Number 15, 6'1 sophomore. He had a phenomenal game last game. The sophomore, Derek Jackson. He's putting together a pretty good tournament. It'll be interesting to see how he comes out and play. Great athlete, great player. And lastly, number 24, DJ Thomas, the 6'5 senior. And that's really going to be the challenge tonight, is the athleticism of Piper and their down guard play here. And then you got, for the Blue Comets, you got Jordan Duncan starting. You got Rhett Smith. You got Caden Seamster. Elliot Stevenson. My man Larson Kester, L Boogie, starting the ballgame, our normal starters. Blue Comets were able to pull out a tough win last night against Andover Central. Came down to the stretch, and Larson Kester and Elliot Stevenson stepped up and helped us pull that one out. We're going to have some fun tonight. It's going to be a game of runs, and it's true, the Pirates have some athletes on the floor, but as we saw in the game against Shawnee Mission South, they have their moments. So the Blue Comets, they play the game right. We can pull out a win here tonight. I'm DJ Dangerfield. So glad you're tuning in to the 52nd Annual Ralph Miller Classic. That's Kerr and Seamster getting it on. Seamster didn't even jump. Kerr didn't know what to do with that. It's kind of like a, that's a little like a Freudian trick there. He didn't know what to do with that. He didn't see Seamster jump. There's Walton. A little penetration there on Smith. Gets in the lane. It's going to be a turnover. First one of the game for Piper. Here comes Elliott Stevenson. Up the floor to Larson Kester. Layup missed. And here comes Piper. There's Jackson on the far wing. Shoots a three. He can heat the gym up pretty quick. Misses that far three. Rebound by Kerr. Goes inside to Moore. Moore off the glass and good. The first two for him. And Walton and Moore, two really good guards. Moore very competitive. Another turnover for the Blue Comets. No, not quite. Almost a turnover. Lowe's both Moore and Walton. Really good guards. Man-to-man defense being played here by Piper. Here's Kester. Far wing. Good screen by Seamster for Stevenson. Off the mark. Jordan Duncan, though, comes away with that long rebound. He's going to keep it. Off the glass. No good. Nice drive, unable to finish it. Down the floor to DJ Thomas on the run. 2 points. Thomas, good job running the floor, and Pirates get out here early by four. Here comes Seamster. Blocked by Kerr off the glass. Up the floor to Jackson. Jackson off the glass. A little lackadaisical. Up the floor to Seamster now. Jackson, this coach, like, my bad. He might have used that, had to use that. I usually give a kid a one my bad card. You get one my bad card a game. After that, I'm coming after you. There's Seamster on the block against Kerr. Seamster, ooh, nice spin move to the baseline there. Seamster takes it up and strong and scores it. His first two of the night. Seamster quietly, he's faced foul trouble in this tournament. He's done a good job in this tournament, Seamster has. He's stolen away by Moore after the miss. Blue Comets' first turnover of the night. Man-to-man defense here by Piper. There's Duncan, the three-point contest winner, and he knocks it down. Airness, Air Jordan. Another three for him. I'd like to see us get the ball to him more. And the Blue Comets take their first lead of this ball game. I'd like to see Duncan get more looks. Man, I'd like to see his teammates get him the ball more. I don't understand. Man, listen, I got a shooter like that on my team. I'm trying to get him the ball every trip. There's Walton for three. Off the mark. There's a push. Good call. That's a good call on Thomas. Lance Walton, a really good shooter also. But Jordan Duncan won the three-point shooting contest for the second year in a row. And when his feet get set, there's a good chance he's knocking it down. 4:50 here in the first quarter. Both these teams, it's going to come down to the bench play. Both these teams need the players that come off the bench to play well. Harding, Bilby, we may see Baker a little bit. We need them to play well. Kester with some penetration. Gets out to Duncan again, another three. Oh, just in and out. He kind of backed up off that three that time. Just rimmed out. Here's Moore to Thomas. Gets inside, throws up a shot, no good. Good job by Rich Smith, ripping down that rebound. Rich Smith had some foul trouble in the last game. Rich Smith on the cut. Over Kerr, no good. Here comes Jackson. Thomas is running the floor hard again. And boy, he sprints the floor well. There's Jackson to Walton. Over to Jackson. He likes that shot. Kerr gets the offensive rebound. He puts it back in. Kerr's a tough kid. 6'6 senior. He can jump out the gym too. You got to put a body on him. Got to find him and put a body on him. 3:30 to go. And Piper takes back the lead, 6-5. Here comes Elliott cutting through. Seamster looking, penetrates on Kerr. Out to Kester, long three on the wing. Ooh, in and out. That's a shot he normally hits. Kerr looking at what he's got against Seamster. Drives, gets him in the air, off the glass, and good. Kerr got Seamster in the air, was able to score. And that's four for Kerr, back-to-back baskets for him, and a three-point lead now for the Pirates. Pirates are wearing their purple. They've been wearing purple the whole tournament. Blue Commons in their white. They've been wearing their white. This is for third place. Actually, this would be for second place, excuse me. Not for third place. This is games for second place. Seamster off the miss there. Down the floor they go. There's Thomas. Ooh, just missed a tough one there. Here comes Duncan. He's going to push it. Gets up the floor to Rhett Smith. Rhett Smith against Jackson. The layup is good. Good job by Smith. He got that ball in between him and his body and was able to finish that basket there. More now. Good screen by Kerr. Switch there by the Blue Comets. There's Walton in the corner. He likes that three. He hits it, and he can shoot the three. Probably their best three-point shooter. Jackson's a streaky shooter. But as far as straight up shooting the ball, Walton's probably the best. There's going to be timeout on the floor, literally. Crabtree called timeout as Kester falls on the floor. And we'll take a 30-second timeout with them. It's the 52nd annual Ralph Miller Classic here on Comet Vision.
Sensing that human touch at your bank? At Community National Bank and Trust, you'll be able to talk with a real person. Community National Bank is small enough to know you, yet big enough to offer the best products. Your busy lifestyle requires banking options like mobile deposit and people-to-people pay. With locations in Southeast Kansas and Southwest Missouri, Community National Bank and Trust can help keep your finances safe and your spending smarter. Online at mybankcnb.com. Community National Bank and Trust. Federally insured. Locally awesome. Member FDIC.
Back here in Chanute, Ralph Miller Classic, number 52. Second place game here between the Chanute Blue Comets and the Piper Pirates. Kessler's got his work cut out for him. Got some great guards he's playing against out on the floor, trying to bring it up under the pressure on them. Here's Kester now looking at what he's got. Inside to Harding. Harding draws the foul. And Harding checked into the ball game for the Blue Comets. He came in for Smith. And then you got Roth for Thomas for Piper. And then you got Alomar Brooks. He comes in the ball game for Walton. So Harding goes to the line, misses his first free throw. Harding does a great job when he catches the ball on the blocks. He usually scores it. He draws the foul. He goes 1-for-2 that trip. 1:30 to go here in the first quarter. The Blue Comets down by 3. There's Jackson with the deep penetration, and they're going to call a foul on someone. Maybe on Seamster or Harding, I'm not sure. Oh, they called on Kester there. Kester gets his first foul of the game. Here's Moore working against Duncan. Screen by Roth. Moore gets it back to Roth on the pick and roll. He falls into some trouble, but Kerr cuts through. Great cut by Kerr and great awareness by Roth. Now 5-point lead, largest lead of the game for Piper here coming towards the minute mark here in this first quarter. Seamster going against Kerr. Tough shot. They're going to call a foul there. Call a foul on Kerr. Seamster got to the line there. So Seamster's going to shoot two here tonight. And that's a matchup you want to keep an eye on. That's Kerr's first foul. You're going to keep an eye on this matchup. Between Kerr and Seamster. Luke Hammond's now 2-for-4 from the free throw line. Walton checks in for Jackson now. Jackson, one of the younger guys that you'll see playing this ball game, just a sophomore. Brooks is also a sophomore for Piper. Great penetration by Walton. Harding gets up in the air and gets the rebound. Brooks is only a sophomore, too, and Harding's only a sophomore. Those are the youngins on the court. 30 seconds. Luke Hammond's down by 4 here. That's Walton guarding Kester there. And that's Brooks guarding Harding there. Both two sophomores guarding. And then Kester catches down low. Great finish by Kester. His first two of the night. Now a two-point game, 10 seconds to go. Walton has it. Kester's guarding him. 5 seconds. Roth sets a screen. Then here comes Kerr. Walton doesn't want anything to do with the screen. Excuse me. Moore doesn't want anything to do with the screen. And he scores that right before the horn. He gets it in there right before the horn. And that's how we'll end the first quarter here. Luke Hammond's down by 4. 52nd annual Ralph Miller Classic. Your own Comet Vision.
Whether you're completing home repairs, weekend projects, or planning your garden for spring, Cleaver Farm and Home, 2103 South Santa Fe, has a carefully selected inventory for all of your paint, hardware, and building needs. Cleaver's also offers free delivery for cat and dog food if ordered online at www.cleaverfarm.com. Cleaver supports the youth outreach of the Fire Escape Youth Ministry and is happy to underwrite KFEX Radio. Thank you, Cleaver family. We appreciate your support.
KFEX Firescape Radio programming is made possible in part by the underwriting efforts of Sonic Drive-In of Chanute. Sonic Drive-In of Chanute does not consider community involvement a sales gimmick or a public relations ploy. They see it as a way to be a good neighbor and as a way to have a positive impact on their community. It is for these reasons that Sonic Drive-In of Chanute is a proud underwriter of KFEX Firescape Radio and the ministry efforts of the entire Firescape ministry to the youth of Chanute.
Back here in Chanute, 52nd annual Ralph Miller Classic. Starting the second quarter here, the Blue Comets down by 4. Kester, Stevenson, Seamster, Harding, and Duncan on the floor for Chanute. Jordan Duncan on the floor for the Pirates. Walton, Moore, Roth, Thomas, and Brooks. Turnover, Blue Comets here. Here comes Moore. Look how fast Moore is. Blue Comet's second turnover here of this half. Come away with nothing there off that turnover, though. Seems to run into trouble. Gets it to Duncan. Duncan penetrates off the glass. Good. Good job by Duncan. Staying with it. He has 5 here in the first half. 2-point lead. Now you got a great, nice backdoor cut by Roth, unable to do anything with it. Kind of an errant pass by Moore. And he shoots a floater and unable to finish that. Now the Blue Comets have a chance to tie or take the lead with a long one. Seamster being guarded by Thomas. Seamster gets the drive to the cup and he'll be fouled. Great job by Seamster here in the first half of getting into the paint with the basketball. He's being guarded by Kerr and Thomas. He's got tough. Got some tough guys guarding him. You know Seamster's up for the challenge. Seamster going to the line. He's 1-for-2 tonight. Excuse me, that's his first free throws here. Ooh, in and out. In and out. Thomas over to Roth. There's Walton. Jackson being guarded by Harding. Two sophomores guarding each other. Walton pump fakes. Over to Thomas. DJ Thomas for the 3. No good. Get Harding ripped down that rebound. He's going to push it down here. Good job by Harding holding this team honest. Look at Rhett Smith with the catch. Oh, it just throws it away. Turnover number three for the Blue Comets. Right idea, just a little too much English on it. Jalen Duncan is now going to check in for Seamster. Seamster, good minutes by Seamster. Long three by Roth. He'll hit that. Ooh, just short. Rebound Brooks. Ooh, Kester drew a charge there. Yeah, no call. Oh, they do call it. Man, good job by Kester on Brooks. Kester took great rebound by Alomar. He got up, came down with it. Kester, instead of getting the rebound, said, I'll get the charge. 1 point lead right now for Piper. 5:50 to go here. Up, oh, Stevenson picked up his dribble. Kester being guarded by Roth. Good job by Kester getting into the lanes. Gets it to Harding. Harding cross court pass to Stevenson. Stevenson gets down the lane and the finish. His first two of the half. And the Blue Comets take a 1 point lead. Great drive by Stevenson. And here we go. That bench is talking over there. I like that. Ooh, Kester had opportunity there. Didn't quite get the ball. Walton to Roth. Off the mark. Loose ball. We'll stay here. I don't know what's going to do. Blue Comets. Checking in the ball game for the Pirates will be Moore and Kerr. They're coming in for Roth and Brooks. Roth had a couple good looks for three, unable to knock them down. Blue Comets now the 1 point lead. Jordan Duncan setting up to come back in the ball game. Here's Harding working against Jackson. Harding gets it to the right hand now, center of the court. A great post by Stevenson on Jackson. Layup off the glass, no good. Good post by Stevenson. Unable to finish that. Here comes Thomas now to Moore. He avoids the charge, misses the layup though. He was very much aware of Kester, who was able to get around Kester, but unable to finish. We saw Piper miss a lot of layups in their last game. Walton tried to get a steal. Rhett Smith though, was able to stay with it. Kester with a good drive. Double clutch. Kester has four. Blue Comets 3 point lead. And Blue Comets going to stretch that lead. It's going to come down and get in the stop. This is the second place game here. Here's Walton now going against Jalen Duncan. Out to Moore. Over Kester for three. Off the mark. Rebound Harding. Harding is doing a good job rebounding the ball. Here's Elliott. Blue Comets running through their motion offense here. Cutting and trying to get mismatches on them switches. There's Jalen now on the block. Gives up to Smith. Smith off the glass. Great pass. Great finish. Smith now has four. He's guarding Jalen is guarding Walton. Walton comes off the screen. Boy, he knocks it down. He has five now. 3 point lead for the Blue Comets. Blue Comets had their largest lead of the game there, a 5 point lead. And then Walton comes in, pulls it back to three. Harden in some trouble. Duncan was open. Jalen was open on that far side cutter, but there's no way you could see on the double there. And you'll see the Pirates do that every so often on the wing. They'll trap. Elliott Stevenson, boy, he almost, I'll call it offensive foul. Elliott Stevenson with offhand. He pushes off with his offhand there. Both refs saw it. We're going to go back the other way. And Jordan Duncan's checking in for Kester. Good minutes by Larson Kester. El Boogie doing his job out there. That'll be Elliott's first foul. Blue Comets' first team foul here. Second place matchup here in the Ralph Miller Classic. I'm DJ Dangerfield. Great ball game brewing up here, folks. They've all been good. There's Thomas now for Piper. Over to Walton being guarded by Jalen Duncan. Good job by Jalen. It's a foul. Jalen doing a good job holding his ground. And, you know, for being a freshman, Jalen Duncan's a freshman. He's a strong kid. You're not just going to run him over. You're not just going to bully him. He's a strong kid. He's in the weight room. He's poised. And one thing I love about Duncan, he's confident. Oh, great look inside to Kerr. And Seamster gets called for the foul. He got Seamster in the air. Good job on that out-of-bounds play.
You guys are the winners.
Kerr's going to shoot two here. Kerr already has six. His first free throw attempts tonight for the Piper.
Who are the winners for the Hoops for Cash? Come down to the...
Kerr shot that one short. Kerr shot that one short. It's 0 for 1.
Devin Kerr at the line.
Second free throw on the way. He knocks it down. He has 7 of their 18 right now, does Devin Kerr, the senior. He's putting together a really good tournament. Here comes Harding. Great penetration. Oh, just left it short. It was good penetration. And there's Jackson on the break with Kerr coming, and he throws it down. Great lob, great finish by Kerr from Jackson. Kerr has 9 now. Tie ball game, 2:20 to go. Ooh, dangerous pass there by Duncan. There's Smith. Great pass to Jordan over to Seamster. Oh, blocked by Kerr. Good block by Kerr's long. He's long. He's athletic. There goes Jackson now. Pull-up jumper by Jackson off the mark. Ripped down by Jalen Duncan. He's gone. They call double. Jalen was gone. He was gone. That's the Blue Comets' 4th turnover. 1:55 to go in this tie game. There's Walton working against Duncan. Ooh, turnover. I was just going to say, we haven't seen very many turnovers by Piper. That time, Thomas tried to get to Kerr. Turnover number 2.
Yeah, the winning ticket, Hoops for Cash, number 400138 and 400138.
1:40 to go here. 20-20. A little pressure here by Jackson and Kerr on Harding. Get over to Seamster. Boy, he just barely got over that 10-second mark there. Rhett with the penetration. Oh, turnover, Blue Comets. That's number 5 of the half. Here comes Jackson. Out to Walton. Ooh, Walton shaking and baking there. Inside to Moore. Moore in some traffic. Gets his own rebound and finishes. Moore has 6. One thing about Moore and Kerr, if they miss the first one, they are quick jumpers. They know how to get off the floor quickly. Some guys have that gift, that ability. Quick jumpers. So as you're going down to go up, they're already up getting the basketball. And so Moore and Kerr do a good job of rebounding off their own misses just because of how fast they're able to get the basketball. Russell Westbrook the same way, not the highest jumper on the floor, but the quickest jumper. Kester comes in for Smith. Foul was called on number 15, Jackson. Derek Jackson for the Pirates. That's his first. Blue Comets down by 2 here under about 50 seconds. Kester down low. Tough shot, misses it. Walton batters, Kester batters. They're going to stay here with the Blue Comets. Tough bunnies being missed this whole tournament. And I've seen it in just basketball in general. It just seems like more and more guys miss those inside looks. Blue Comets been up by 5, as much as 5. Pirates have been up as much as 4. Harding gets his shot blocked by Kerr. Look at Kerr get down the floor. Look at Kerr get down the floor. He was tripped. This kid looks to get down the floor really well. They're going to call a double dribble on Moore. And that's Piper's 3rd turnover. 2 turnovers in this quarter. 2 turnovers here in the last 2 minutes for Piper. A little indecisive there. They're up by 2 with 36 seconds left to go. Moore going to put that pressure on him. Moore is a basketball player for sure. You can just tell the kids that love the game. He doesn't take any breaks on the floor, pressures the ball, plays in the passing lanes. Seamster now being doubled by Moore and Thomas. That's tough. That's too tough. Too tough to try to score on. Foul that time was on Thomas. He reached in for no reason there. Harding's going to go back to the, excuse me, Seamster going back to the line. He's 2 for 4 tonight from the line. Need these two.
Third time, Thomas.
Seamster has five. Thomas has to sit. He has two. Roth comes in for him. 14 seconds to go in the half. Seamster misses one. And they're going to call Daniels, they're going to call Duncan, Jalen Duncan, for a foul. Stevenson will check in for Jalen Duncan. Blue Comets down by one here, 13 seconds to go in the half. This is the second place game here, 52nd annual Ralph Miller contest, at Ralph Miller Classic. Inside to Kerr, great pass. Kerr misses his own layup, gets his own shot. Roth with the left-hand hook, no good. Roth not happy with himself, and that's how we'll end the half. But the Blue Comets down by one, the 52nd annual Ralph Miller Classic. Great game brewing up here for second place. You want to stay here. More basketball action coming here on Comet Vision.
Fire Escape Coffee House is dedicated to high school and college students. Our mission is for every student in Southeast Kansas to know they have value, they are loved, and that they have a place. We are not a church, but we are motivated by the love God has for all of us. The Fire Escape opened in 1998 and is open every Friday and Saturday night for high school and college-age students. During the week, the Fire Escape is open to the public Tuesday through Friday mornings for coffee, catch-ups, or small groups like Bible studies. The Fire Escape Coffee House is proud to partner with the Chanute High School Tech classes on this broadcast.
Cut. Beautiful. Okay, let's go again.
Tell me about your vision.
At the end of the day, it's your classic coming-of-age story.
Can I need more shipping labels?
All the gig speed, fiber-fueled internet you need to take whatever and make it big. Sparklight Internet, a stronger connection.
$10 for a free throw.
Come on, the legs. More knees, there you go, follow through. There you go, all right, $15 free throw, and now, three-pointer. $15 for a three-pointer. All right, our 36th rep, good job, Camry. $15, all right, are you ready, Brennan? All right, get the free throw. And a $10 free throw. Now he's got a $15 three-pointer. Almost. There he goes, almost. $100. All right, give her a hand, Kimberly Redemarker. Three-pointers, and our very own Jordan Duncan, first place, back-to-back champ for 2 years, Jordan Duncan, our three-point champion this morning. And in our dunk contest, Alamar Brooks from Casey Piper took third, Connor Kerrigan from Shawnee Mission South took second, and for Piper, our champion for our dunk contest, our first place guy, Devin Kerr.
From kickoff to the final lap, from Pee Wees to the weekend pros, our team of doctors can help with the diagnosis and treatment of sports-related injuries. Wherever you are in your sports journey, Labatt Health Sports Medicine Team has the training, experience, and skill to repair, restore, and renew. For more information about Southeast Kansas' leading orthopedic and sports medicine program, go to labetthealth.com.
The Medicine Shop Pharmacy, located right across the street from Royster Middle School in downtown Chanute, is in the business of making you feel better, faster. With three licensed pharmacists, the Medicine Shop has the knowledge to know the right drugs and the proper dosage to ensure your safety. If you're not quite up to your game, Medicine Shop offers delivery to your door. The Medicine Shop, a proud underwriter of the Chanute Blue Comets.
Home Savings Bank is a platinum underwriter here at the Fire Escape Confiance. Home Savings Bank has been serving the Chanute area since 1886. Customer-owned and customer-driven, Home Savings Bank, located at 214 North Lincoln Avenue in Chanute, Kansas, is here to serve all your banking needs. Whether your needs are checking, savings account, safety deposit box, lending, or online banking, Home Savings Bank is here to help. Home Savings Bank is located on the internet at homesavingschanute.com. Home Savings Bank is committed to the youth of Southeast Kansas and helping the ministries at the Fire Escape Coffee House.
Thank you.
gentlemen, ready for another exciting half of this matchup between the KC Piper Pirates and your very own.
Back here in Chanute, Kansas, with your beloved Chanute Blue Comets. 52nd annual Ralph Miller Classic, fighting for second place. They're taking on the Piper Pirates here, and this is going to be a good second half. I got Jordan Duncan, Rhett Smith, Caden Seamster, Larson Kester, and Elliot Stevenson on the floor. The Blue Comets on the floor for Piper. Lance Walton, PJ Moore, DJ Thomas, Devin Kerr, and Derek Jackson. And we have yet to see, Derek Jackson has the high, guys. He scored 23 points yesterday. That's the high of this tournament. Individual high points scored, and he hasn't scored in this game yet. So we're gonna, and the Blue Comets come out with a turnover. Good, great job by Rhett Smith hanging on that ball. That could have got away from him. Oh, Jordan, I thought he had a shot there. There's Kester for three, good! And the Blue Comets take back the lead. Kester's first three, he has seven tonight. Blue Comets not by two. The Blue Comets have led his bunches by five tonight. And now you got DJ Thomas for a three off the mark. Stevenson battles and pulls down the rebound, and here he comes. Blue Comets now pick up the pace. We've had a tough time in this tournament in the third quarter. Ooh, blocked by Kerr. We've had a tough time in the third quarter in this tournament. He scored 9 points the first night, six last night in the third. You see this change a little bit. There's Derek Jackson over to Kerr. Good. He ties the ball game up. Kerr has 11 now. He's in double digits. Kerr had 14 the first game, 12 yesterday, and he has 11 tonight. He's probably going to be playing somewhere on Saturdays, I assume. Oh, Jordan Duncan was gathering himself. The ball went out of bounds. A little low on that pass, but he's still catchable. Got a weird bounce. Blue Comets, their first turnover. Tie game here. This is for second place here, the 52nd annual Ralph Miller Classic. Running through their offense. Back screen for Thomas, not there. There's Moore, he takes a three, in and out. That's Moore's first three attempt of the night. Oh, Kester thought about it. There's Stevenson on the drive, pulls up with his right hand, good. Stevenson had two in the first half, that gives him four so far. We need to see him get going here. Blue Comets now back up by two. Man-to-man defense by the Blue Comets. Walton, 10-footer, good. 2 points. He has seven. Walton has a good tournament, too. He had 16 in the first game and 11 last night. He has seven tonight. They're back in the zone. And there's Duncan for three. Boom! And it's good. That's his second one. Duncan has eight. That's the most he scored in this tournament so far. Blue Comets now up by three. And I'm telling you, we got to figure out how to get him the ball. Ooh, long three by Walton. He can do it now. He can do it. He has 10 now. Walton. There's Duncan again. Hot. Heat check, unable to get it, but Ellis Stevens rips down the offensive rebound and then fouled by DJ Thomas. Just so you know, I failed to mention, Alamar Brooks came in for Derek Jackson. I failed to mention that. A new sub coming in for the Pirates, and I don't even have him in my books. I don't have number 11. I'm going to listen closely to the broadcast where number 11 comes in. There's Elliot Stevenson shooting a free throw. It's off the mark. Blue Comets are 4-for-8 as a team. Odd thing going on here. It's a lane by I don't have number 11. I don't know his name. Sorry, bud. Harris Stevenson makes the second one. He has five now. The fouls. Duncan gets called for the block. That's our first team foul. Alamar Brooks is going to go to the line.
Alamar Brooks to the line.
Piper's 2-for-2 from the free throw line today. They didn't shoot their first free throws till like a minute to go in the second quarter. Alamar Brooks, the sophomore. Second one good, and Alamar Brooks gets on the board. He had four last night. Pressure picked up by, almost stolen away by Moore. Pressure being picked up by Piper with Jackson and Thomas over here on the bench. We haven't seen Vogel yet. We also have Eric Siegel over here. I don't see Roth at all on the bench. Up the floor, the Comets go. A foul's committed. Duncan's going to get to shoot two. So number 11 picks up his first personal. Great job by Stevenson. Great penetration. There's Roth. There he is. He's down there. I couldn't see him. I was getting nervous for Piper here. Seems to just missed a cutter there. There's Duncan now. They're going to run through their set again. You see the Blue Comets run through this set a lot. They're looking for a cutter in the middle of the floor here. Stevenson, penetration. Triple team there. Here comes Brooks. A charge call. On Brooks.
Charging foul call.
Duncan was able to sneak in there and get the charging call.
Brooks. This is third personal. 13
Brooks tries to take it from Duncan. Over to Stevenson. Penetrates there. Layup off the glass. Good. That's seven for him. Five in this quarter for Stevenson. Long three by Walton. Every time. Yes. Eight in this quarter. And Piper takes a one-point lead, and that kid can shoot the ball. He may not have won the three-point contest. There's ice in his veins when this ball is thrown in the air. There's Smith. Cross-court pass to Seamster for three over in the corner. Short. Picked up by number 11. Ooh, almost stolen away by that. Red Smith. There's Walton. Look at Walton, man. My goodness. Walton taking over. He has 10 points in this quarter, 15 in this game. His tournament high is 16 the very first night. Now a three-point lead by Piper. 2:42 to go here in the third quarter. Kester over to Duncan for three in the corner. Boom! Duncan ties it up. My man Jordan, that's his third three of this game. He has 11. His tournament high. Ooh, Walton for three. Boom! And he has 13 in this quarter. 18 for the game. Back to a three-point lead. Walton has put the team on his back. Kester, tough layup, missed. Here comes Brooks on the break. He's got people running with him. Brooks crosses it over. Off the glass. Oh, just missed a tough one, Brooks did. They're going to call him for the reach. Sometimes you don't finish, you foul. It's a common thing in basketball. Brooks gets his fourth. Jackson now checks in for number 11. I'm going to try to go down to the court and get that young man's name just in case he subs back in. Down the floor to Duncan. He's open. Pump fakes, gets Brooks in the air, and that's it for Brooks. That's it for Brooks. That's number five. Coach was just coming with a sub with Vogel. He was just coming with Johnny Vogel as a sub. Eric Siegel just checked in. Jordan's going to shoot two free throws here. It's off the mark. We're 5-for-11 as a team from the free throw line. Derek Jackson is sitting down with Vogel coming in the ball game here. 1:50 to go. Second free throw is up. Jordan Duncan goes 1-for-2. We got a timeout on the floor, and we'll take a timeout too. We'll take a 30-second timeout here. The 52nd annual Ralph Miller Classic here on Comet Vision.
Sing that human touch at your bank. At Community National Bank and Trust, you'll be able to talk with a real person. Community National Bank is small enough to know you, yet big enough to offer the best products. Your busy lifestyle requires banking options like mobile deposit and people-to-people pay. With locations in Southeast Kansas and Southwest Missouri, Community National Bank and Trust can help keep your finances safe and your spending smarter. Online at mybankcnb.com. Community National Bank and Trust. Federally insured. Locally awesome. Member FDIC.
Back here in Chanute, Kansas, the 52nd annual Ralph Miller Classic. We got a good one for second place going on here. KC Piper Pirates up by two behind the leadership of Lance Walton. He's got three threes in this quarter, 13 points total in this quarter. He's got 18 points in the game, and it's been all the Lance Walton show here in this third quarter. Blue comments. Jordan Duncan's got a couple threes in this quarter. He's got 7 points. Elliot Stevenson's got 5. Blue comments drop back in their 2-1-2. Give them a different look here. Harding's in the ball game. Stevenson, Seamster, Jordan Duncan, and Kester in the ball game for the Blue comments. On the floor for the Pirates is Vogel, Siegel, Moore, Kerr, and Walton. They're going to have to get penetration. They're going to have to get penetration if they're going to do something. There's Vogel with the open three. His first look of the game. Off the mark, rebound Stevenson. Vogel's first look of the game. Here comes Kester now. They're matching up. Piper still in their matchup. Don't be surprised if Piper has to, because of foul trouble, have to go into a zone here at some point. Harden being guarded by Vogel. Vogel up on him competing. Vogel's a 5'9 junior. Oh, Harden, who almost got called for one. Careful with that offhand. There's Kester under some pressure, gets it to Seamster. Seamster in the middle of the lane, over Vogel, gets his own rebound, up and over again. Seamster misses both. And here comes, look at Walton in the corner. Ooh, I was going to say, boy, hey, that's a grown man's shot. The Seagulls will get called for a foul, and Duncan's going to shoot two. And this is where the Blue Comets have struggled. The Blue Comets 6-for-12 now from the free throw line. And Jordan Duncan did a great job boxing out Siegel. Drew a foul. It's a chance for the Blue Comets to tie here, right at about 30 seconds to go in the third quarter. Roth just got up to check into the ball game. And Duncan shot up and good. And boy, Duncan has put together a good third quarter. He's got eight. Roth comes in for more. One to tie, and he knocks it down. Big shots by the senior there. Jordan's got nine in this quarter. 14 for the game. He's having his best tournament game, probably his best game this senior year. Comets are in that zone, that 2-1-2 zone. Roth, ooh, almost threw it away. Here's Vogel, his second three of the night try. No good, he's 0 for 2 now. In and out. Here comes Kester, setting up for Duncan. No, Kester sets up for himself, and he hit it down. And that's just a two at the buzzer. And that's how we'll end it. The Comets on top by two, 40 to 38. Here going into the fourth quarter, 52nd annual Ralph Miller Classic. You want to stay here. Second place ball game going down here in Chanute, Kansas. Look at that.
Kester for the buzzer beater.
Whether you're completing home repairs, weekend projects, or planning your garden for spring, Cleaver Farm and Home, 2103 South Santa Fe, has a carefully selected inventory for all of your paint, hardware, and building needs. Cleaver's also offers free delivery for cat and dog food if ordered online at www.cleaverfarm.com. Cleaver supports the youth outreach of the Fire Escape Youth Ministry and is happy to underwrite KFEX Radio. Thank you, Cleaver family. We appreciate your support.
Here we go, fourth quarter here for second place. Blue Comets up by two here at the Ralph Miller Classic. I'm DJ Dangerfield. You got Elliot Stevenson, Arson Kester, Caden Seamster, Chris Harding, Jordan Duncan on the floor for the Blue Comets. On the floor for the KC Piper Pirates, you got Walton, you got Roth, you got Siegel, you got Kerr, you got Vogel. Man-to-man defense by Piper. Begin the fourth quarter. And they're going underneath here. Maybe a push by Vogel on Kester. Yeah, push by Vogel on Kester. It's actually the right call. Vogel was pushing. Up top here to Kester. He's being guarded by Roth. There's Harding being guarded by Vogel. And now Seamster with the penetration. Gathers himself, blocked by Kerr, foul called. Good job by Seamster. He was unable to score in the third quarter, so we wanted to see him do something here. Foul was called on Siegel, his second. Seems his free throw is off. Moore checks in. Derek Jackson also checks in. He checks in for Vogel and Siegel. Blue Commons up by two. Seems at the line again. He knocks that one down. Seamster has six now. Three-point lead. Blue Comets have been up by as much as five in this ball game. They're dropping to a 2-3 now. Derek Jackson puts the ball on the floor. 10-footer off the mark. Battle by Curry. Pulls it down over Elliot Stevenson. Takes it back up. Misses a tough one. Kerr rips it down. Battles. We got a jump ball between him and Seamster. And Kerr misses some easy shots there. Showing a little frustration. Just kind of want to get your head together. Gather yourself. This is the time now for mental toughness. Kind of gather yourself, get your thoughts together, and finish. Who throws it away? Does Walton, and here comes Duncan. Gives up to Harding. Harding loses it. So back-to-back turnovers by both teams. That's seventh turnover for the Blue Comets, fifth for Piper in this game. Walton pull-up jumper, good. And he keeps it rolling. That's 20 for him. 20 for him, 15 in the second half, and thrown away by Harding. Oh, boy, that's three turnovers for Commons. Two turnovers in a row. Oh, no, they're saying. Oh, no. Coach disagrees with that call, apparently. So not a turnover. Close. Close. Blue Commons a one-point lead here in the fourth quarter, 6:40. There's Seamster being guarded by Thomas. Catch of the penetration on Jackson. We have a whistle blown on Jackson. Third team foul here. Well, they're calling this thing tight. First foul on Jackson. Kester gives it to Stevenson. Stevenson off the glass, no good. Rebound Kerr. Foul on Kester. One-point game here in the fourth quarter. Kester's second foul. This is coming down to be a quite the second-place game here. Blue Commons in a 2-3. Trying to get something for Lance. Walton there. Jackson gets in the lane. Tough shot off the glass. He knocks it down. That's his first two here in the ball game for Jackson. Ooh, he almost got a foul there. There's Harding up the floor. Under pressure from Jackson. Elliott Stevenson is going to grab it. 50-50 ball there by Elliott Stevenson. There's Kester with the fake. Being guarded by Kerr in the corner. Inside of Stevenson, turns, hook shot, good. Stevenson has seven in the half. He has seven and a half, nine for the game, and timeout on the floor. We're going to keep it here with 5:43 to go. Blue Commons take a one-point lead and kind of reset this thing right now. Right now it's a very, very touch-and-go ball game here. Both teams battling out. What you're seeing happen, the Blue Commons are falling back into a zone. So I don't know if Coach Crabtree is going to try to mix that defense up now. We've seen the Blue Commons do a 2-1-2 and a 2-3 zone, just trying to give Piper something different to look at. And the Blue Commons have been able to take the lead within that zone. And Piper, we've seen several players that haven't played at all this tournament come in the game for them. So they're using everything they got. He's, the coach over here is using every resource he's got in this ball game. Let's start off here. Here comes Piper Jackson. You got Jackson, Walton, Moore, Kerr, and Thomas on the floor for Piper. For the Blue Commons, you got Stevenson, Kester, Jordan Duncan, Chris Harding, and Caden Seamster for the Commons. There's Kerr against, and boy, Seamster's done a great job against Kerr. Double Jackson, stolen away by the Commons. Here comes Seamster, he's got to finish that. Off the glass, good. Great job by the Blue Commons there. Great finish. That's the third turnover for Piper in this half and six for the game. And then Lance Walton comes out with another three, y'all. Goodness gracious. His fourth three of this ball game. Excuse me, fifth three of this ball game. And I mean, this dude is balling. It's a tie ball game. This is for second place. Ref is counting out here front. There's Stevenson now in penetration to Kester. Back to Stevenson. He's been guarded by Walton there, folks. Up front, that's Walton. He's having a great tournament. Double, double, double. Seamster, he better get rid of that thing. Somehow Harding's able to recover it. 4:25 to go here. There's Duncan. Somehow get him the ball. Get him a look here for three. Duncan back to Kester. Kester penetrates on Jackson. Goes up strong. He's fouled. Oh! Tough move by Kester. Drew the foul on Moore. He's going to go to the line and shoot two. That's Moore's second foul. Blue Commons struggle from the line, though. They're 9 for 16 from the free throw line tonight. And a struggle for them. That's Moore's second. It's going to be Piper's fourth team foul. So that means the Blue Commons will be shooting two free throws the rest of this fourth quarter, which is a big deal, folks. Some big free throws for the senior here. He made a couple of big free throws last night down the stretch. This is the front end of two. Here comes the second one. Second shot is up and it's good. Blue Comets have 10 points from the line and they're up by one. Kester's first points of the fourth quarter. Ooh, almost thrown away, but Walt was able to recover it. That was almost, I don't know how he got that ball back. Look at Walt with the penetration. Ah, pull up. Good job. Good defense by Seamster. Stolen away by Kester. Here they come on the break. Oh, and then given right back by Kester. And there's Thomas for the easy layup for two. And boy, I tell you what, Thomas hasn't scored since the first quarter. He needed that one. He has four, and back to a one-point lead for Piper. Man, we got to figure out how to get Duncan the ball here. There's Harding open on the block. Stevenson able to get him the ball. This has been a game of runs, but I tell you what, these two teams match up really well. Ooh, great fake by Seamster. Gets him in the air. Up and under. Count it. Oh, man. Foul is going to be called on Kerr. Ten points now for Kester. Shoot another free throw here. He struggled from the line a little bit. We need him to knock this down. Good. It's a two-point lead now for the Blue Comets. Coming 3 minutes here. Inside to Kerr. Kerr off the glass. No good. Thomas battles. Kerr gets his own rebound. He does it a lot. Shots up and good. And foul on Kester. And Kerr comes back and gets his own and one. That's the third foul on Kester. Kerr has 13. He scored 14 in the first game, 12 in last night's game, and he has 13. So he's had a great tournament. He has a chance to give him a one-point lead. And Kerr does that. Three of the old-fashioned way, and he gets the job done. Pirates are 4 for 5 from the free throw line. Here comes Seamster. Oh, turnover for the Blue Comets. That's turnover number 4 in this quarter, in this half, I mean. Derek Jackson with the layup. Tough layup. He finishes it. Now a 3-point lead for Pirates. Here comes Harding now. Double gets himself with a little jump stop, and Harding with the finish off the glass. His first two of the half. He has three in the game. He hasn't scored since the first quarter, a free throw. Now 1-point game, 2:25 to go. Here's Jackson over to Walton. He's been knocking this down. Number six, maybe. He's going to shoot it again. My goodness. And that's the 6-3 of the night. And timeout on the floor. And this dude is balling. Timeout on the floor. 4-point lead now, 30-second timeout. We'll take a 30-second timeout also here. Comet Vision.
KFEX Firescape Radio programming is made possible in part by the underwriting efforts of Sonic Drive-In of Chanute. Sonic Drive-In of Chanute does not consider community involvement a sales gimmick or a public relations ploy. They see it as a way to be a good neighbor and as a way to have a positive impact on their community. It is for these reasons that Sonic Drive-In of Chanute is a proud underwriter of KFEX Firescape Radio and the ministry efforts of the entire Firescape ministry to the youth of Chanute.
We are back here in Chanute, Kansas. Chanute Blue Comets down by 4 here in the fourth quarter. This ties the largest lead that Piper's had in this game. They've been up by 4 a couple of times. Blue Comets in the basket here. On the floor for the Comets are Chris Harding, Larson Kester, Jordan Duncan, Elliott Stevenson, Caden Seams from the floor for the Pirates. P.J. Moore, Lance Walton, Devin Kerr, D.J. Thomas, and Derek Jackson for Piper. What a ball game, folks. Here's Kester cruising down the lane. Gets to Elliott Stevenson. Little body, no call. Late call. Late call. Thomas is going to get to shoot, too. Oh, man, that's tough. That's the third foul there on Derek Jackson. Sometimes refs don't make it easy on themselves. The Blue Comets, 11 for 20 from the free throw line. The problem isn't that he called a foul. The problem is when he called the foul. It's like he waited to see if he'd make it or not, then he called it. That's old school. Ooh, Walton. Walton has 21 in this half, 26 in this game. With P.J. Moore. Kerr to Moore. 5-point lead. And Stevenson now going against Thomas. Good help by Moore. 5-point lead, 125 to go here in this ball game. Stevenson. Over to Duncan. Duncan eyes it up for three. Good. Timeout on the floor. Duncan hits his fourth three of this ball game. Blue Comets call it, take a full timeout. We'll take a 30-second timeout. It's the 52nd annual Ralph Miller Classic, the battle for second place tonight. Blue Comets down by two. We'll be right back with more on Comet Vision.
Firescape Coffee House is dedicated to high school and college students. Our mission is for every student in Southeast Kansas to know they have value, they are loved, and that they have a place. We are not a church, but we are motivated by the love God has for all of us. The Firescape opened in 1998 and is open every Friday and Saturday night for high school and college-age students. During the week, the Firescape is open to the public Tuesday through Friday mornings for coffee, ketchups, or small groups like Bible studies. The Firescape Coffee House is proud to partner with the Chanute High School Tech Classes on this broadcast.
Back here in Chanute, another barn burner. All six of these games have just been some good ball games for the most part. Blue Comets now down by two. This is for second place. Shawnee Mission South won the first place game here earlier this afternoon. Blue Comets fighting for second place. Out on the floor for Piper, it's Lance Walton. He has like 26, y'all. Derek Jackson, he's the one who has the ball right now. P.J. Moore is out there. D.J. Thomas is out there. And Devin Kerr is out there for Piper. For the Blue Comets, Larson Kester, Jordan Duncan, Elliott Stevenson, Chris Harding, Caden Seamster on the floor. Blue Comets in man-to-man defense. Under a minute now. Some pressure there by Kester. And Jackson. Look at Lance Walton. Good screen by Thomas. Walton. They're counting. The ref is counting over there. They call a foul on Elliott Stevenson. That'll be the third team foul for the Blue Comets. And they're going to need to. They got two fouls to give here. That's Stevenson's second foul. So Blue Comets got to try to get a steal here. Only four turnovers in this half. Seven for the game for foul by Kester, that'll be his fourth, I believe. Fourth team foul.
Foul on Lars Kester, his fourth personal foul, fourth team foul.
40 seconds to go. The wrong side of the floor. Move it over here. Wrong side of the floor there. Good officiating. Blue Comets got to try to get a turnover here. Trap of some sort. Ooh, B.J. Moore turns the corner. They call a foul on Jordan Duncan, and now we're in the bonus. Get the shoot two. So B.J. Moore's going to go to the line. Pirates are 4-for-5 from the free throw line tonight. This is Moore's first free throws, which is amazing as much as he plays around the basket. His first free throw is up, and it's good. He has 9 so far tonight. The Blue Commons is going to come down to free throws. They're 12 for 21. Well, there's comeback and hot in a game like today's. Kerr got the rebound. All right, we got 34 seconds here. Oh, Seamster tried to come back, and nice try by Seamster. And that'll send Derek Jackson to the line. He's going to shoot 2.
His second personal foul.
Derek Jackson, just a sophomore. He has 4 tonight. His first chance to go to the line. Three-point lead right now for Piper. Trying to turn this into a 2-possession game, and Derek Jackson does. I mean, cool as the other side of the pillow here. Second free throw's up. It's no good. And they're going to call Kerr. They're going over the back. Some shenanigans going on down there. Gonna be a foul. It's gonna be a foul on Kerr. That'll be his third. Seamster. It's gonna be shooting 2. Seamster was letting Kerr know. No business for you to be on my back like that. And then Thomas came down to say something to Seamster, and Seamster pushed both of them off of him. And then we had a little acting job by Kerr. Seamster knocks it down. And it looks like the Blue Commons call a timeout here. We're going to stay here, 56-59. Let's go, 3-point lead here. This game's for second place if you're watching at home. So a little shenanigans down here. Kerr trying to sell the forearm shiver from Seamster. Oh, man, yeah. Little acting job there. So Coach Crabtree is drawing up the defense. This is what we're going to do if we make it. This is what we're going to do if we miss it. And you're going for a steal first. You want to try to get a good, solid trap. And then if they get out of the trap, you want to fly out of that trap and either get a hard foul or a tip coming up from behind. And so this is going to be a significant thing here. It's just a 1-possession ball game. So the Blue Commons, this is a lot of time on this clock. On the floor for the Commons, Seamster, Duncan, Elliott Stevenson, Harding, Kester. Free throw on the way. And Seamster knocks them both down. Good job. And timeout on the floor. We'll stay here. Good job by Seamster here. Seamster, he has 7 of his points from the free throw line tonight. He has 13. It's a 2-point game here with 33 seconds on the going. Roth is now checking in. He's coming in for Thomas, and Vogel's checking in for Derek Jackson. That's an interesting sub by Piper. We want to pay attention to that. They got Roth and Vogel checking in for Jackson and Thomas. Let's see what Coach is up to here. He's up to something. Blue Commons have their same 5. So for Piper right now, you got Roth, you got Jackson, you got Thomas, you got Brooks, and you got Walton. So it looks like, that Vogel subbed for. It There's more who vocal sub for. And over on the blue comments, you got Harding, you got Kester, you got Seamster, you got Jordan Duncan, you got Elliot Stevenson. Blue comments down by two here. Blue comments came into this quarter with the lead. This has been a close game. We've seen several ties, several lead changes in this ball game. It's been anybody's ball game this whole game. Right now, if you're the Blue Comets, it's going to come down into easy missed shots and to free throws. There it is to Roth quickly. There's Vogel up the floor to Jackson. Jordan fouls him. They took about 10 seconds off the clock. Trying to see if you can't get the sophomore to miss one of these. He did. He was 1 for 2 his last trip. He's the right one to foul. They're 6 for 9 from the free throw line. See what the sophomore's got. He steps up. He knocks that down pretty easy. He knocked that down like he's been there before. He has 6. P.J. Moore and D.J. Thomas both come back in for Vogel and for Roth. They did their jobs. Here's Jackson one more time. It's an interesting sub there by Coach. I mean, boy, Derek Jackson comes up and knocks both down. Here comes Harden. It's a two-possession ball game here. Harden down the floor. Gives it to Seamster. Seamster, long three. Stevenson fights for it, loses it out of bounds. Seamster took a long, long three there. Here comes Roth and Vogel. They're doing an offense-defense sub here for Thomas and Moore. Now Vogel's going to throw it here up next to the Blue Comets. There's Jackson again, fouled by Chris Harding. This game is for second place here. Blue Comets, Piper battled all night. Battled all afternoon, excuse me. It's the 52nd annual Ralph Miller Classic. What a tournament. Shawnee Mission South took first home in the first game. You got to tip your hat to Derek Jackson here. The sophomore just comes up to the free throw line and knocks them all down as Moore and Thomas come back in. No problem. Really, the story of the game is Lance Walton.
2 points, Derek Jackson.
Blue Comets get on the floor quickly. Inside to Harding. Harding knocks it down really quick. Clock keeps ticking. Blue Comets gonna let it tick, down by 4. And that'll do it. Piper will take home second place here after some phenomenal shooting from Lance Walton. Lance Walton came out here, man. 8, 10, 22, 24, 26, 29 points. Lance Walton, including 7 threes. 29 points off of 7 threes tonight by Lance Walton. And he had a good game for the Pirates tonight. Great job by Jordan Duncan. He hit 4 threes tonight. And he finished with 17. And so he had his best Ralph Miller in his career. Good night for him. Kester also finished with 10 tonight, alongside Elliot Stevenson, who came home with 9 of his own. And Seamster finished with 13. Chris Harden with 5. Rich Smith with 4. That's how it looked tonight. So tip of that to the Blue Comets. They lose 2, win 1. Some tough, close games. And the Ralph Miller, man, this was a great Ralph Miller. I've enjoyed doing all these games with all these schools. It's been a lot of fun. I appreciate everybody and their support. Good job by the young people. Production team, I'm DJ Dangerfield. I'm out of here. This concludes the 52nd annual Ralph Miller Classic on Comet Vision. Good afternoon.
From Principal Zach Murray, congratulations to the Piper men's team, our 2024 Ralph Miller's second place team. Congratulations, gentlemen. And now for the Ralph Miller Classic 2024 All Tournament Team. So number one,
first place for the all-tournament team. And these are voted on by the coaches for the player.